Hello, everybody, and welcome in for another edition of Black Bears Hockey here on YouTube. Brooks Hill and my partner Cole Parenti will join us in just a moment. Game 56 of the FPHL season. It feels like so long ago. It was mid-October, and now being mid-April, the Black Bears regular season comes to a conclusion here tonight against the rivals down I-86 Highway 17. The Elmira River Sharks come into town with playoff desperation for the final spot in the Empire Division. Cole, a team by the end of the night is going to play Binghamton next weekend in the first round. It's either going to be the Elmira River Sharks or the Watertown Wolves.
Yeah, and Elmira has Withville to thank. They did a job last night taking down the Wolves in regulation 4-2, and now it all comes down to this. This is the game to decide it. And Brooks, what a story. It's bookended this season for the Black Bears. It started here with the River Sharks. It'll end here with the River Sharks. But never have they seen a more hungry and more desperate River Sharks team than they will see tonight. Jake Schultz makes his return to the Visions Veteran Memorial Arena, this time as an opponent. Mathieu Boylard makes his return, still as a friendly face.
That's the voice of Cole Parenti up here in the Jeff Guys Auto Sales broadcast booth. Super producer Peter, once again, back on the ones and twos for us here tonight. Big opportunity for the Black Bears to end Elmira's season here tonight and send them packing for the summer. We'll see what they do when we start the show in just a little bit. We're going to go ahead and run our Tully's Coach's Corner because Coach Shored was feeling pretty liberal with his time today during the sit-down interview. It's the last one of the regular season, so why not? It's a good 5 minutes with head coach Brant Sherwood, so we're going to go ahead and throw it down to the locker room right now.
Inside the Tully's Coach's Corner, game 56 of the regular season. You blink and it flies by from October to April. Here, Coach Sherwood, you guys with perhaps one of the most gutsy wins of the season last night without your top 6 point getters on the team, storm back from behind to defeat Danbury in their home barn as you guys get your third shootout victory of the season. I gotta know, how does that one feel compared to the other 54 games that you've already played?
Well, I know you can see me right now, and I'm smiling because it was just such a cool effort, just, like, not going into that game, like, thinking, oh, like, we don't have our guys. We're not going to get it done. They knew they were going to get it done, and then it kind of was the thing I was telling them before the game about, like, hey, like, this is like a kind of testament to you guys knowing that you could be a first liner on any other team in this league, but you choose to be here. You choose to be part of a great program, and that like you don't want to be the guy that's looking for individual accolades. You want to be the guy that's on a championship team and moving up that way. So it was awesome to see you guys step up and kind of give that reassurance that we have the deepest team in the league.
You know, speaking of that depth, out of the 4 goal scorers last night, Tosto had the game winner in the shootout, so I know that one's a little bit iffy in the stat column, but Romakers and Stefan come up with big goals in that game, and those are guys who joined the team late in the season. What does that mean for you guys, having those depth guys who, you know what, they weren't here the entire season like a JT Walters was or a Dan Stone who's played in every game this year, but they're contributing right now to this team and making that final push into next week where the big dance essentially starts?
Yeah, it means everything because we, being a new coach, I didn't know how much depth you actually needed going into playoffs, and I found that out last year with a few injuries in the second round. So when that happened, our lineup got a little bit depleted, but like bringing in a guy like Kyle Stefan and taking that risk of knowing, hey, like, he hasn't played in 3 years, trying to find his legs underneath him, and that kid just worked his tail off every single day, and it's really paying dividends right now. And then Rammer, just, like, super positive all the time, whether he's in or out of the lineup, just awesome guy to be around, cool dude, and cashes in on the power play when he gets an opportunity in the bumper position. It's just, like, everyone's stepping up, and there's one guy I'd like to, you know, note is Utes, Utorial. So, like, he came in, he had a hot start with us, and it was a lot of goal scoring and stuff, but the way he played last night and kind of the position he's put in on this team now with, like, possible 10th forward, possible third line, stuff like that, he's developed into a great forechecker, a great pest, and just seeing him get in that fight, our whole team just, like, erupted on the bench. It was so cool to just see a different side of his game, and these guys are really just buying into the whole team concept.
That's an awesome story to hear about Utoro and some of the other guys who are buying into what you've been selling all year long for the Black Bears. It crossed my mind about halfway through the game, and I'm sure it hit your mind a little bit sooner, but at some point, did you notice that your entire first power play unit were healthy extras last night?
Yes, I did.
When you were going through the lineup?
Oh, I did, and, like, Weber, he's joking around. He's like, PP3 is going, and they really were, and that just, you know, kind of solidifies in my brain that we do have guys that can step up in the special teams department, whether it's hopping in on the PK, hopping in on the PP. Like, guys are knocking at the door, and then when the opportunity presents itself, they don't blink and they just take advantage of it. That 5-minute power play, it really changed the game. Like, Fletch kind of drawing the penalty and being annoying and getting Pamelaine off his game was great to see. We go up for 5 minutes and capitalize twice on it. I mean, it's like exactly what needed to happen after being down 2-0. Like, these boys are resilient. I'm excited to see what they're gonna do tonight too.
Yeah, Fletcher definitely took one for the team last night, that's for sure. I didn't ask to see it, but he was very liberal in describing what he felt like and what he was seeing downstairs. But Coach, thank you for your time. We appreciate it. Congratulations on making it to the end of the season, Empire Division champions. And we'll talk to you next week for the first round of the playoffs, no matter who the opponent is.
Appreciate it, Brooksy. Love working with you, and congratulations on Broadcaster of the Year. You're the man, and it's a pleasure to see you every single day, buddy.
Oh, thank you. I feel the same way about you, too. That's the voice of head coach Brant Sherwood. More coming up after these messages here on the Triple Cities Family Dental Pregame Show.
Fans, some exciting news. The next Black Bears home game will be round one of the Commissioner's Cup playoffs. And to celebrate the occasion, the Black Bears are offering $5 select 16-ounce beers on the concourse while supplies last. Grab your tickets now at BinghamtonBlackBears.com, and we can't wait to see you for the playoffs.
Should I get a COVID vaccine? I have concerns.
Are there still health risks associated with COVID if I don't get a vaccine?
Does getting the vaccine protect others around me?
The answer is yes. Getting the COVID vaccine protects you from serious illness and those around you that you may expose, especially those with certain health issues. Ask your healthcare professional about your concerns and the easiest way for you to get a vaccine. Remember, it's not just COVID.
All about you make me think of good things.
Good day.
Let common tempers down.
Good day.
Good-natured Canadian Pilsner.
Welcome back in, everybody. Triple City's Family Dental pregame show wrapping up here tonight as the Black Bears make their way out of the tunnel for the final time this regular season, donning what was new at one point, but probably just normal now, the green alternate jersey for Binghamton. EJ Worth did an excellent job designing a new alternate logo this season for the Bears. Put it together with a little bit of inspiration from an NHL team and put together these masterclass jerseys here that they are donning tonight for the final time this season. Elmira making their way out onto the ice as well. They are circling around. We'll throw it down to Frank Perney for the presentation of the national anthem.
Please welcome Maine and Well High School Treble Chorus.
Our
excellent job on that chorus, rendition of the national anthem. Not done yet. We have a ceremonial puck drop and right back over to Frank Perney.
Fans dropping tonight's ceremonial puck, please welcome United States Representative of New York's 19th Congressional District, Mark Molinaro.
Getting a look at United States Representative of New York's 19th District, Mark Molinaro, and his children dropping some ceremonial puck drops here tonight on the final game of the FPHL season. Cole, it's not going to be the only one we pay attention to tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, who's ready for good hockey?
Well, it looks like Mark is fired up and ready for hockey.
Yeah, who isn't ready for the regular season finale?
Short, sweet, to the point.
Does he represent Elmira too? Does he know he's got stake in both sides?
That's a good politician.
Hey, I'm preparing. I'm ready.
Tonight's starting lineup brought to you by our friends over at A&C Heating and Cooling for the Binghamton Black Bears. Cam Clark, Tyson Kirkby, Austin Thompson up front for the Black Bears, along with Vaughn and Stone on the blue line. Thompson and Johnson Equipment Company got all sorts of order. Sammy Bernard against Connor McAnanima. Bernard, 15-16-2, 355 goals against average. Save percentage of 913. McAnanima, 18-3-4, 236, 920 save percentage. And we are officially underway for the final game of the FPHL season for both of these two clubs. Kirkby back into the lineup after receiving the night off. Lost the handle on the puck. Clink comes in. A shot off the mask of McAnanima. A big first save for the Black Bears netminder. And now Clark exits the zone for Binghamton. Now Thompson on a backhander, easily steered aside by Bernard. Binghamton got down in a 2-0 hole last night in Danbury. Guilty of a shorthanded goal and a power play goal in the final 5 seconds. Clark's takeaway bid goes wide over to Tyson Kirkby. Binghamton able to battle back. They did not lead that game for 1 second of game time. They won it in the shootout thanks to the man, Blake Tosto.
With Colin Fitzgerald playing today, Brooks, we can rest easy. He's got through his 15 games. As he's on the ice getting the puck right now, he'll be set for the playoffs. And wasn't easy going 15 in a row, but Colin up to the task.
Stretch pass up to Tosto. This one deflects off of the plexiglass and in behind Bernard, where he'll have to steer it on the backhand. Elmira tries to clear, temporarily kept in by Tosto, but an errant pass puts the Black Bears in a delayed offside situation, so they're just dump it in and go to work on the forecheck. Kyle Steffen, second line center here for the second night in a row. He too has completed his 15 games to be eligible for the playoffs. Wilson's shot drifting wide of the net, but McAnanima will glove it down anyway. That's our first stoppage at 18:21 of the opening period.
It's been a long season, a long grind to get here. The Black Bears sitting pretty atop the division. They know that they have guaranteed at least two more games after this. Elmira still fighting to make sure their season doesn't end here tonight on the ice it started on.
So as it stands right now, Elmira has a 2-point lead over Watertown. The Wolves are taking on the Blue Ridge Bobcats on the road down in Virginia tonight. So now Wilson for the River Sharks fires one. That's blockered away by Mack and Anima into the corner. Utoro out on the ice. Utoro was playing as one of those eight forwards last night. Took his first pro fight last night. And Josh Fletcher now gets into a skate race with Austin Pickford. Pickford able to make the play and skate it over to Kyle Powell, the former Black Bear. But Cole, I know you weren't at the DIA with us last night, but you were able to watch the game as well as many others across the league. What did you like about Andrew Utoro's performance last night?
I was shocked when I saw those gloves drop, and I loved every minute of it. Utoro, a scrappy young player, he came into this organization knowing what he was needed for, and he's executed that perfectly. Coach Sherwood found a diamond in the rough with this guy, and it's worked out perfectly.
Heard that in Artelli's Coach's Corner interview about how proud he is of Utoro. Guy who came in, saw some scoring right away, but then kind of hit a wall and has consistently stayed near the bottom of the lineup for the Black Bears, but hasn't complained one bit about his ice time, and when his number's called, he's ready to go. Now Austin Thompson's number is getting called at the red line while the Black Bears are in the process of changing the defenseman. Bernard just wants to melt it down. Just about 3 minutes gone here in the opening Dragon Billiards Instruction first period. Dragon Billiards Instruction for all your billiards needs. Learn, shop, repair their store in Vestal, or visit them online anytime at dragonbilliardsinstruction.com.
As Tyson Kirkby just skated off the ice, you know he's going to be looking for the back of the net. Nobody wants to be stuck on 39 to end the season. He's going to go for that first 40-goal season of his career.
So Jake Schultz, the former Black Bear, playing his first game of the season against his former team. This one gets elevated into the neutral zone and flown ahead. Now Schultz takes a hit from Blake Tosto. A lot of fans voicing their concern that Schultz is going to try to take a fight with a couple of the Black players, Black Bears players here tonight. And I think for Binghamton, it's nothing really on their mind.
Yeah, they don't really seem to be bothered by it, and they know if it does happen that they can stand their ground. They got some tough guys down there, and I don't think they're really rattled. I think they're here just to play some hockey.
Just talking with Cameron Clark on the bus ride home from last night as Elmira centers that puck out into the neutral zone. Delayed offsides gives me a chance to finish this point. Cam said every time he lined up against Danbury last night for a center ice faceoff, or a faceoff rather as a centerman, he just said, hey, let's just play hockey. Let's just do that. Little laugh here and there.
Got to keep it light, Brooks. Always makes it more fun.
Absolutely. Bond shot blockered away by Bernard as it makes its way down low. PV chops at it. Somro pulls it off the end wall, and Steven Klink able to brush it off a Somro stick. Binghamton, though, trying to re-enter the zone extremely quickly. Somro ran out of real estate, and he's brushed off the puck, giving it right back to the River Sharks.
I love the jump the Black Bears have come out with. They could have mailed this one in, figuring there was nothing really to play for, but it looks like they look like they're taking pride in trying to end Elmira's season early.
You never want to send the fans on home ice home with a sour taste in their mouth, especially before the playoffs, knowing that this is a very well chance scenario that these two teams end up meeting each other next week. Fitzgerald chopping it ahead, down low, Elijah Wilson over to Jasso. Jasso tried to throw one, it goes off the skate of Fitzgerald. Taken away by Pickford. Linesman gets in the way inadvertently, but back across. Wide open man is Jasso, and he looks up to the heavens as he misses everything, and it rattles around the boards all the way back into the Elmira end. Yarwood will settle it down. Everybody's circling the Elmira net. Tanner Coleman, gets this puck deep. Mack and Anima has plenty of time and space to leave it to Mattu Boylar back for his second game. This is game number 20 of the season with the Black Bears for Boylar, who spent some time in the SPHL with the Fayetteville Marksmen and the Knoxville Ice Bears.
Always a fan favorite, number 28, the French-Canadian. Fans have seen him since the beginning, and they love every minute of him on the ice.
There's Boylar's slap shot. Didn't get a ton on that one, but still enough for Bernard to make a save. And that sends us to our first timeout of the night. 14:18 left to go. Back with you after this.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet, so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks. Fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
For discounted name brand clothing and footwear for the whole family, Homer Men and Boys Store is the place to shop. In business since 1951, our woman-owned family business is known for treating their customers like family. And there's nothing more important to us than backing every sale with friendly service. Come visit us to see the largest pair of jeans in the world. Come see what we have for you.
Welcome back in, everybody. Dragon Billiards Instruction first period. 5 minutes and 42 seconds gone here in this one. Still searching for the game's first goal. Shots early favor the Black Bears, 4-3.
Yeah, it's been a jump from both sides. Elmira knowing that they are on the line here trying to extend their season, needing some help from the guys down in Blue Ridge, some former teammates with Nikita Ivashkin and Josh Newberg down there. So some of these guys played, but the Black Bears seem to be taking pride in trying to end Elmira's run.
Excellent face-off win by Elmira right over to Steven Klink. Unfortunately, left the puck back at the blue line, and Dan Weaver able to feather it ahead to the captain to get this puck deep. Schultz will slap it back out into the neutral zone, and the Black Bears will regroup in the middle third of the ice. So Bernard will steer it over for Kyle Powell on the backhand, goes off the skate of Austin Thompson. Deflects off a couple of sticks back out into the Binghamton end. Parker applying pressure on the forecheck. Couldn't catch up to Boylar. It's a stretch pass across the ice for Kirkby, who just tries to throw it towards the net. Good things happen. Clark's shot right off the bottom of the mask, and that'll force a stoppage.
Well, Clark's got a howitzer, doesn't he, Brooks? It knocks Sammy Bernard's mask clean off. And I'm sure Bernard will be a little worried when Cam Clark gets that puck on his stick next.
Like Bernard will readjust. Make sure all those straps are still secured. You can tell right away that he was trying to shake that thing off.
Well,
in the bottom.
Yeah, never safe to play. There's head coach Brent Sherwood and JT Walters not in the lineup tonight, but behind the bench. Never safe to play with an unstrapped helmet, so the best thing to do is shake it off and get a whistle to set it back up.
Stefan wins the faceoff back cleanly to Bond. Now Tosto, the hero of last night with that 91 magic, puts one towards the net. It hit Brett Parker on the way through, and then Parker receives a shove from Connor Smith for his trouble on blocking that Tosto shot. Smith's centering pass deflects off of a body, and Klink will elevate that from the red line into the far corner. Now Dan Stone playing it off the wall. Garwood will take a stride and pick it back up in his own end. It's a turnover. Stefan, his pass too far ahead of Tosto. Maybe didn't know he had that much time. He could have settled it down as Stefan takes a shot. Seeing guy puck deflected off a stick, and Bernard had to be ready from that one from Bond. Shot from a wide angle is caught by McAnanimal, and here hang on for that one.
I don't think Stefan realized he had Connor Smith open in the slot after that takeaway. Smith was yelling. You could hear him up here, but Stefan decides to throw it down low to Tosto. Always a safe play just to throw the puck back in the zone. Just a little bit of a wobbly puck. I'm sure next time he'll make sure to settle it. Dan Stone playing in game 56 of 56, Brooks. Only the third Black Bear to play in every game of a regular season, so that's no easy feat. Congratulations to him.
Yeah, Gino D'Angelo and Josh Newberg did it the first year of the Black Bears season. Nobody did it last year in the second campaign for the Black Bears, and now Dan Stone is the only player in year three to acquire that honor. Utoro getting some stick wax, but a takeaway for Logar. Shot deflects off of the bottom of the stick into the crest of Bernard, and linesman going to separate the two sides here before anything spills over just about 8 minutes in.
Yeah, that was Pickford and Somero, and you know Justin Somero's not going to back down when he's in the slot area right in front of the blue paint looking for any sort of rebound, and Pickford took exception.
Yep, and we learned last night that Andrew Utoro's not going to shy away either.
No, he's not.
Kirby wins the faceoff back to Fitzgerald, able to steer it on the backhand. Clark, a shot from just outside the blue paint, is frozen by Bernard.
Elmira's got to tighten up the defense. They can't allow the puck to get down low to Cam Clark like that. They need to stop passes from getting through and get their sticks in lanes. If you don't do that, it's going to be a recipe for disaster.
Peavy wins this one back away from Kirkby, but a good job on the far wall by Clark to seal, keeping this puck in the Elmira zone for the time being. Steered out on the backhand off a skate. Binghamton with the takeaway. Anderson playing catch with Tyson Kirkby. Those two will trade spots, and it's poked off a Kirkby stick by Gignat. He goes in for a breakaway, and Mackinanima flashes the leather right there with his best save early in this one.
Yeah, that was the defenseman Connor Gignac jumping the rush. Here it is again. He pokes this puck away, kind of rolled on him a little bit. Took him a little while to get it, only had a few seconds to snap it. Gets a pretty good piece of wood on that shot. And Mackinanima up to the task.
So now Peavy trying to find it in the center, or excuse me, in the faceoff circle. Binghamton will be the team that does. Passed up the wall by Tosto. And Stefan using his frame right there to shield the Elmira player away from the puck. Tosto right behind the net. He starts and stops. And given a shove for his troubles, back up to the blue line. Anderson playing catch with Stefan. They try to thread the needle right there on a high saucer. Nothing doing for the Black Bears this time around. Could be a two-on-one. Newman ahead to Klink, just goes underneath the stick of the young rookie. Stephen Klink named to the Empire Division Rookie All-Stars, along with Dan Stone and Connor Smith. Turnaround bid just goes wide, just so over to the rebound. He's trying to dance around Fitzgerald. His centering pass finds a stick of a player in a green jersey instead of one in a white one. And now Schultz will come back into the zone. He has a wrister blocked by Anderson and chopped ahead by Fitzgerald, gloved down by Powell. Seeing guy shot hit Gallega on the way through, falls into the corner. Now behind the net, Jasso looking for Powell in the one-timing bid. Hits a stick on the way through, believe it was once again Fitzgerald. So longest amount of offensive zone time so far here tonight for Elmira. Anderson throws it in off the wall to the far side. Fletcher flying into the zone along with Logar. Logar tries to put it through the legs of Schultz. Nothing doing from the big man there. Now Logar, low angle, caught immediately by Bernard. 9:56 left to go here, first period. Back with you after this.
When you care about something, you take care to protect it. The family that depends on you and the future you're planning for them.
You'll have your own college stories too someday.
With sound advice, smart strategies, and a broad variety of life insurance options, Security Mutual can help provide for the people you care about and also help you reach your financial goals.
It's a sound plan. The time to start thinking about college
and retirement is now.
Security Mutual Life, the company that cares.
There's our good friend, the Mott's, the season ticket holders of the game, brought to you by our good friends over at Courtside Bar and Grill, right in downtown Binghamton. Still searching for the game's first goal. 10 minutes and 4 seconds into this one.
Some great chances from Elmira on that last offensive flurry, just not able to find the back of the net, as now the Black Bears get a chance to set up.
But a large shot, knuckles through. And it finds its way over to the stick of Josh Fletcher. Now Boylar, a lot more space this time. He fires a silent wrist shot, hit a defenseman's stick on the way through, and this one's going to come out back to Mackinanima on the opposite end of the ice. Got to be careful with the goaltenders playing the puck. Will say that led to a Danbury goal last night. A funky bounce off the wall helped out Johnny Ruiz take the puck away from Nolan Egbert. It was the game's first goal, and it also came shorthanded.
Shorthanded goals just kind of take the momentum out of the power play, so the Black Bears don't want to be giving up that first goal, especially up a man.
So Elmira controls their own destiny. They win tonight. They are in the playoffs. Watertown not being able to catch them. If Watertown wins, as this puck gets deflected into the net, Elmira's going to have to secure at least 1 point.
So a lot to play for Elmira. They're not just trying to get to that extra period. They're trying to take this one all the way and win it and make sure that they ensure themselves a spot in the Commissioner Cup playoffs. They want to be back here next Saturday, and they want to have game one up in Elmira on Friday.
Kirkby gets control of the puck after the scramble inside the faceoff circle. Clark trying to get it ahead to the defenseman, Bond. And Binghamton's going to be able to skate this puck through the neutral zone. Kirkby cuts in through the middle, dropping it back for Thompson. A wrist shot, hit a body. Loose puck is behind the net, cleaned up by Schultz. And here play it to the centerman, Blake Peavy. Clink, skate to stick. Back across for the former Black Bear captain, Schultz, taking a couple of whacks at it. Nobody there. And Bond able to reverse it around. As Tyson Kirkby leads the four-man breakout for the Black Bears. Across, Bond skates in, backhander denied, loose puck in the blue paint. It's still available. Referee says, come on, guys, we got to find it. Bond throws it towards the net. There's a big battle in front between Thompson and Schultz, and Thompson is not backing down. Low angle shot from Clark, steered aside by Bernard. Played around the wall, and it takes a funny bounce off of the stanchion of glass and into the crowd. Out of play.
Schultz and Thompson been going at it since the opening draw, still with some words for each other, as Austin Thompson has been known to frequent that area in front of the blue paint and not one to back down from any challenge, so I expect to watch that for the rest of the night.
Now Elmira off the faceoff win will play it ahead to Colin Fitzgerald inadvertently, and that results in a hand pass. So there is a stoppage right in front of the Black Bears bench.
Yep, and Coach Sherwood and Coach George look to be more than happy with who they have on the ice, so they're going to leave everything as it is.
Rasmus Asp, former Delaware Thunder member, served as the assistant captain all season long here with the Elmira River Sharks. Gets this puck deep. He used to be the biggest guy on the team. Now it's Jake Schultz.
Yeah, he's been real important to them with Stavros Soilis on the shelf for the majority of the season, their captain.
Tosto giving chase in the far corner with the puck. Ends up right in front of the Black Bears locker room door. They reverse it around for Fitzgerald, and Fitzgerald is able to get it outside the zone, at least deep enough where Elmira is going to be forced to touch up. Coleman settling it, throws it towards the mixer. Nobody home for Elmira. Pickford into the blue paint. Save made by McAnanima. A wrap chance denied. And rolled off the stick of Newman. Still searching for the game's first goal here. Could be a big one. Somro shot through traffic. Easily seen by Bernard. Here make the save with 6:51 left to go here in the opening frame.
Both teams getting pucks to the net. Binghamton doing a little better of a job. They're up in the shots 12-6. Just both goaltenders have been strong in their own crease. And we expect nothing less from Connor McAnanima. He's been strong all season. Sammy Bernard really been the key factor in this Elmira push for the playoffs.
So now Wilson sending it ahead. It's intercepted by Weber. Given right back, though, to Elmira. Gaeta crossing over the line. Wilson throws it right into the bare head of McAnanima. And after that breakaway save by McAnanima, not too many high-danger chances for either side so far here in the opening period, Cole.
Yeah, it's been a strong, strong period for sure. You get a good look at Josh Fletcher. He's going to skate in for the draw against Houston Wilson.
Loud slapper from Yarwood hit a skate. Might have been some friendly fire from Elmira. Stick goes flying. Wilson got it back. Tried to stuff it into the near side post. Nothing available as McAnanima holding the cage tight. Jasso's from a low angle. Blocked by Weber. Remember, Jasso played game one here with the Black Bears this season against Elmira. Was able to score a power play goal. Seems like that was forever ago.
Oh, you could say that again.
Jasso into the middle for Yarwood. Right in between the hashes. Just sent it wide. Another stuff chance tonight. Elmira doing a good job cycling the puck right now. Jasso spins off a hit from Utoro and Boylar. Clink centering pass for Yarwood. Nothing available, and the Black Bears able to get this puck out. Utoro trying to dance around Schultz. He shaves up the ice and retreats. Clark, one-timer. Kirkby tipped just wide. Off of the stick of the Elmira player right in front. Schultz with a big hit for Cam Clark. No loss of love between those two early on.
Did they play together, Brooks, or did Clark come after Schultz had left?
I believe they did not play together. Clink now, skating on ahead. He goes two on two with Parker out wide on the far side. He's sealed off on the wall by Dakota Bond. Bond reclaims control for the Black Bears. Clark towards the middle, trying to get it over to Thompson. Schultz will slap it over to Brett Parker. Not out, held in at the line by Dan Stone. He has a high wrister that was going to be off target, but Bernard wants to catch it and send us to our final timeout of the night. Back with you after this.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Old Vestal Road in Vestal. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Whether you're a high school or college athlete or a weekend warrior, Guthrie is the area's premier sports medicine program, offering injury evaluation, concussion management, physical therapy, and more. With a full team of providers across New York and Pennsylvania offering same or next day appointments, Guthrie gets you back in the game as quickly as possible. Call the Guthrie Sports Medicine team today at 866-GUTHRIE or learn more at guthrie.org/sportsmed.
Welcome back, everybody. Just under 5 minutes left to go here in the Dragon Builders Instruction opening period. Still searching for the game's first goal. Binghamton leading the shots on goal category, however, 13-7. And neither side taking a penalty so far. We played the whole game at 5-on-5.
Yeah, I'm sure that the referees are going to let them play this one out. I don't think they want to make a call that ends up deciding this game. So the Black Bears and River Sharks are going to end this one on their own.
Face off one back to Clark. Arister goes off the glass, stays in. Might have hit a body on the way through. This one's chopped at. The linesman on the near side of the screen did a good job of dodging that puck, getting out of the way. Now Dan Stone joining the rush will just play it around the wall as it takes a ride off the top. Back up to the far blue line for Bond. D to D, Bulldog passing. Now Kirkby coming in, tried to center up for Clark. Got his stick legally impeded on the way through. Stone's wrister goes off of the glove of Newman. That cannot feel good, even with the padding in that glove. Elmira now, another takeover for Binghamton. They gave it away. Thompson's shot, a little drag move, and Bernard ready for it.
I love that play there from Cam Clark. He could have taken the shot with some bodies in front. Instead, elects to go with the extra move, gives it over to Thompson, who had a much wider open lane. He fires, but it's right into the red basket of Bernard, who has stopped all 14 shots the Black Bears have thrown at him.
Face off one back by the River Sharks as Pickford plays it around for Wilson. Elmira does another poor job of trying to get the puck out. Smith's pass over for Stefan. Had a yawning net, but it got partially blocked on the way through by a River Shark defender. Stefan applying pressure down low in the corner. Smith trying to power to the front, and Bernard had to be ready for that one. I think he kicked that one out with his leg. Cross ice pass to Wilson from Pickford. Left behind at the red line. Elmira's just going to get this one deep. Anderson with plenty of time and space for the Black Bears to start the breakout. Stefan, using little real estate on that right side, flies by the Elmira defenders, saucered ahead. Didn't get a tip on that pass. Smith holding with it. His wrists are blocked. It hits Yarwood on the way through, and he's shaken up. And Utoro knocked the net off trying to chase the loose puck, and that'll force a stoppage with 3:20 left to go here in the first period.
Yeah, we know this shot that Connor Smith has. There's no way that felt good. Cam Yarwood favoring that right leg. He's going to have to go right to the bench. Good sign he didn't head down to the locker room, but there it is right off the ankle. Not much protection down there by that ankle, especially as he turns the skate in. So just not so much fun for Cam Yarwood right now is all I could say.
While you guys were enjoying that Heinz Energy replay, linesman resecured the net on the pegs. That's Hunter Mayette, the linesman, dropping the puck. Corey Stahl, his partner. Back at the blue line, officials, Trevor Waite, number 7, and Kyler Spice, number 12. Those are tonight's officials as Somro took a spill on the way through. I think he thinks something's wrong with his skates as he goes off for a line change almost immediately after that quick little flat tire. So we'll see if Dylan Konechny can make a quick pit stop, change out the skate blades for Binghamton's number 10. Clark off the wall ahead for Utoro. Dodges the hit from Peavy. Saw it coming from a mile away. Blade back across for Clark. He skates it past Craig, leaving it for Logar. And big collision through the middle of the ice on Jesse Anderson. Going back now the other way. Waylar able to backhand this one over to Asp, and he will just deposit it into the open corner. So maybe the physicality picking up here in the tail end of the period. Just over 2 minutes and 15 left to go. Still searching for the game's first goal. Big crowd here on hand tonight for the final regular season game of the year for the Black Bears. You know everybody wants to go home with a Burger King coupon tonight. Clark throwing it back, trying to hit Weber in stride, instead hit a body. Kirkby backhands this one in, falls into the corner for Thompson. Picks his head up, centers up, Weber across for the captain. A little behind Kirkby, topping the umbrella is Boylar. His slap shot blocked, bouncing around, and Thompson scores! First goal of the night for the Black Bears. It's Austin Thompson cashing in the rebound.
Heck of a play by Thompson. Not one, but two chances at it. Follows it up, and Bernard just got too far down. Couldn't get himself back into position. And for Mr. Thompson, that's 27, a guy who was disappointed with himself a few weeks ago. I'm sure he's not disappointed anymore, Brooks.
So Binghamton's the team that cashes in first. It's Austin Thompson continuing to whack at it right on the doorstep. And the Black Bears lead 1-0 with the game's opening goal. It's an even strength goal. Did not see one of those last night in the Danbury contest. All the goals between the two sides were either scored shorthanded or on the power play.
Yeah, and it all started with Mathieu Boylard. We saw his offensive game begin to grow as his season with Binghamton started. I'm sure it'll keep going as it comes to an end.
Now Connor Smith turned it over to Jasso's wrister, seen all the way by Mack and Anima, and that's a good bounce back save for Binghamton defensively on the bump up shift from the River Sharks.
Yeah, Mack and Anima is too good of a goalie. You're not going to beat him like that. You got to take his eyes away. You got to tip passes, tip pucks, and you got to make sure you get in those lanes and try to take away anything from him.
So 18:23, time of the goal. Austin Thompson's 27th of the year from Dan Weber. Continuing to impress, back-to-back assists for Dan Weber as there's 60 seconds left to go here in this first period. Mathieu Boylard for the initial shot was also given an assist. That's his 12th of the season. Now Dan Stone, plenty of space behind the net to play the puck up to Cameron Clark. Thompson chasing after it, and Stone, high player for the Black Bears, gets on the forecheck. Love seeing the defense get involved here in game 56. Stan Stone has appeared in all 56. Jussieu and Bond tie up with each other. Looks like nothing's going to result in that. 15 seconds left to go here in this first period. Binghamton leads 1-0. Black Bears making the final push of the frame. Bond comes in, her rapid around the wall. Loose puck between Schultz and Kirkby. Gets knocked away for Clark. Bond tries to throw one towards the net. Nothing will come of it. And that is the end of the first period.
Yeah, strong period from both teams. The Black Bears, the only one able to connect, however, and they'll skate off with a 1-0 lead. I'm sure Coach George will make his adjustments to try to get his team prepared for the second.
So your score after one period of play, Binghamton 1, Elmira yet to score. We have a long way left to go here tonight, and we have an exciting intermission report. We're talking about the playoffs. Again, the Excite Motorsports semifinals going on. Someone's going home with a brand new ATV tonight, and we're going to see that as well. So we're going to timeout, come back. You'll be watching the ATV contest and also hearing about what's going on the out-of-town scoreboard. Back with you after this.
Are you ready to take your billiards game to a whole new level? Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop has everything you need to impress your friends and crush your opponents. American Q Sports certified coach Kim the Dragon Young is now accepting new students. From novices to pros, the Dragon helps you find your best game with in-person or online instruction available worldwide. Need help with stance, stroke, or alignment and aiming? We've got you covered. Looking for advanced cue control techniques and trick shots? No problem. Follow us on Facebook at Dragon Billiards Instruction and Instagram at Dragon Billiards Kim for free daily tips and drills, upcoming tournaments and events, as well as exciting contests and giveaways. Subscribe on Patreon for personalized video content. Visit our online pro shop for the lowest prices on the highest quality pool cues, accessories, and Dragon Billiards gear. Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop, breathing fire into your game.
Well, for the final time this season, Trevor Potenziano driving the ATV around for the semifinal of the Excite Motorsports Chuck-a-Puck promotion. Binghamton leads by one. And before we get to the stats about tonight, it's worth noting that all the people throwing the pucks right now are semifinalists, meaning they've already won in one of the previous 27 home games this year. So a lot less pucks to clean up tonight. And if only one person makes it into the back of the ATV tonight, that person's going home with the ATV. But I think I already see a couple, so it looks like we are going to have a final round during the second intermission.
Yeah, Brooks, I was nervous if none of them made it in what was going to happen, but it looks like we'll get our second round. It's going to be exciting. I think you get a key, and you got to see if you can start it up. And, you know, a lot of these people have gotten pretty good at throwing their chuck-a-pucks over the years.
Absolutely. They've had a lot of practice. It's been a tradition here in Binghamton in season 51 of pro hockey. So very thankful, everybody. Could be participating once again. As Trevor making his final round here, I see at least two. I see three. Somebody made it the last second. So, at least three, maybe more. Going to be in the second intermission activity here. Let's get to the Columbia Mutual Life Insurance stat sheet. Columbia Mutual Life Insurance Company has been protecting families in the Southern Tier for over 140 years. Shots on goal, 16 for Binghamton, 8 for Elmira, but where it matters the most, Binghamton leads by one.
Yeah, and the Black Bears just kept putting that puck on net, kept shooting, kept firing, and eventually it was Austin Thompson able to cash in right there at crease side on Sammy Bernard.
So,
from Dan Weber and Mathieu Boylard. Sorry, Brooks, I lost my train of thought with all these numbers going.
It's okay. It happens to the best of us. And me sometimes.
Oh. Are you not the best of us, FPHL Broadcaster of the Year over here?
Let's not talk about it.
Congrats, Brooks. It's a big deal. I want to congratulate you on the broadcast.
Oh, thank you.
I can read a quote. You said, I want to thank my color commentator, Cole. Without him, this would never have been possible.
You forgot that I had Alex's name in there.
No, this was a separate quote. You said, especially Cole. Without him, I wouldn't be as good as I am. Correct? End quote?
That one doesn't sound like a direct quote, more like a paraphrase.
Well, it was in the article I wrote.
Oh, okay, but not the one that got published. Okay, I see you there.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the look at the Columbia Mutual Life Insurance stat sheet. When we come back, Cole's going to update everybody on the out-of-town scoreboard, what's going on across the FPHL here tonight. We're going to be back after this, folks. Out-of-town scoreboard coming up.
Roman Acres Veterinary Hospital is proud to announce they are now offering urgent care visits from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Sundays beginning April 7th. This service is open for both clients and non-clients alike. If your pet is sick and your primary care vet isn't open, give them a call at 607-656-4285 or visit RomanAcresVet.com for more information.
Are you ready to take your billiards game to a whole new level? Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop has everything you need to impress your friends and crush your opponents. American Q Sports certified coach Kim the Dragon Young is now accepting new students. From novices to pros, the Dragon helps you find your best game with in-person or online instruction available worldwide. Need help with stance, stroke, or alignment and aiming? We've got you covered. Looking for advanced cue control techniques and trick shots? No problem. Follow us on Facebook at Dragon Billiards Instruction and Instagram at Dragon Billiards Kim for free daily tips and drills, upcoming tournaments and events, as well as exciting contests and giveaways. Subscribe on Patreon for personalized video content. Visit our online pro shop for the lowest prices on the highest quality pool cues, accessories, and Dragon Billiards gear. Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop, breathing fire into your game.
When you care about something, you take care to protect it. The family that depends on you and the future you're planning for them.
You'll have your own college stories too someday.
With sound advice, smart strategies, and a broad variety of life insurance options, Security Mutual can help provide for the people you care about and also help you reach your financial goals.
It's a sound plan. The time to start thinking about college
and retirement is now.
Security Mutual Life, the company that cares.
Get access to exclusive player events, monthly parties, and road trips to away Black Bears games. This is what you get when you become a member of the Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Stop by the Booster Club table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game, pick up a 50-50 ticket, and sign up to join for just $10. Stay up to date on the Booster Club by liking their Facebook page, facebook.com/Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Monthly meetings with players, road trips, and a whole lot of fun when you join the Black Bears Booster Club.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Upper Front Street in Binghamton. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet, so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
Oh, a beautiful morning. Oh, a beautiful
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Welcome back inside Visions Veteran Memorial Arena. My name's Cole Prendy alongside Brooks Hill. Binghamton Black Bears up 1-0 against the River Sharks, but let's take a look around the league, and especially at the big game everyone's watching, Watertown versus the Blue Ridge Bobcats, which as of right now reads 1-0 Watertown. They're about to wrap up their first. Over in Fraser, Michigan, Port Huron and Motor City meeting one more time. Motor City leads that one 3-1. Carolina and Columbus also meeting for what could be the final time in the regular season. Most likely to see each other in the postseason. 3-0, the River Dragons lead it in Georgia. And finally, just getting underway, or will be getting underway, I should say, in about 15 minutes, is Mississippi and Baton Rouge. So one more time, let's go around the horn. 3-1 Motor City over Port Huron. Watertown has just scored, making it 2-0 against Blue Ridge. Binghamton up 1-0 on Elmira. Columbus 3-0 over Carolina, and Baton Rouge and Mississippi set to square off.
So that most important game in the FPHO for an Elmira fan tonight is going to be the one against the Bobcats, being Watertown versus Blue Ridge, and Watertown holding a 1-0 lead right now. And actually, just coming through the wire, power play goal from Carter Thornton. Watertown leads 2-0 against the Bobcats. So Watertown applying pressure, and you have to wonder if the River Sharks are scoreboard watching back in the locker room. They need to find a way to manage a point tonight. And with Watertown up 2-0, their mountain to climb is getting a little bit higher.
I'm going to have to check Watertown again because I'm getting from a reliable source that they may be up 3-0 now. Let me give that a quick look. And according down to the Blue Ridge Bobcats, it is 3-0 Watertown, Brooks.
So, 3-0 Watertown leads over Blue Ridge. So even if that game has the stat line, we'd have to wait for this one to go final. They still have 30 seconds left to go in the first period. So we might know the result when we go off the air here tonight on the next Black Bears opponent.
And I'm sure both teams are watching it. Like I said, a few times in the first, Binghamton wanting to end Elmira's season. And, of course, Elmira watching to see what they have to do and make sure that they can get into the playoffs.
All right. That was a look at our out-of-town scoreboard. More coming up. Binghamton Hockey Booster Club highlights coming up in about 4 or so minutes. We'll be back after this, folks.
For discounted name brand clothing and footwear for the whole family, Homer Men and Boys Store is the place to shop. In business since 1951, our woman-owned family business is known for treating their customers like family. And there's nothing more important to us than backing every sale with friendly service. Come visit us to see the largest pair of jeans in the world. Come see what we have for you.
All about you make me think of good things.
Good day.
Let common tempers down.
Good day.
Passing them around.
So stand up and cheer. We'll pass you a beer.
Good day.
Cheer a good-natured Canadian Pilsner.
Awestruck Premium Hard Cider, crafting transcendent, awe-inspiring liquid made and sealed right in Sydney, New York with New York State apples. Improve your day with Awestruck Premium Hard Cider. CryoWorks provides cryotherapy that uses nitrogen-cooled air to target specific areas of pain and inflammation. Local cryotherapy targets a specific area to deliver the same effects of the whole-body cryotherapy to that specific site. Treatments take 5 to 8 minutes, with a benefit exceeding that of hours of icing. Your Binghamton Black Bears, premier choice of cryotherapy, CryoWorks.
Stay in the swing of things with your golf game this winter and check out Fairways Indoor Golf Company. At Fairways, you can play any 3 state-of-the-art golf simulators. Enjoy your favorite cocktail in the lounge by the fire or watch your favorite sports team on over 9 82-inch TVs. The only slice you'll experience will be from the homemade pizza from the clubhouse kitchen. Bring your own clubs or use theirs. Get the golfer in your life a Fairways gift certificate. Tee off with Fairways Golf Company, 511 Hooper Road, Endwell, online at fairwaysindoor.golf.
Are you compassionate and interested in providing care to people with developmental disabilities? Check out a New York State career with Broome OPWDD. Enjoy great benefits such as job security, health insurance, retirement plan, paid time off, opportunities for advancement, and so much more. Positions as direct support professionals in the community or at a secure facility might be exactly the change of pace that you're looking for. For more information, call 607-240-4786 or go online to www.opwdd.ny.gov.
We have a huge selection of vehicles and every tool available to fit everyone's credit needs. If you've been told no before,
I say no when it feels so good to say yes.
Get the vehicle you deserve.
Yes! That's awesome!
With our guaranteed credit approval program, which can easily be filled out online at jeffkies.com.
Jeff Kies Auto Sales, Apple Lincoln, go with the winner, Jeff Kies.
Are you planning on traveling to Binghamton for an upcoming Black Bears game? If so, check out La Quinta Inn and Suites by Wyndham for a night away from home. La Quinta Inn and Suites is a short drive from the arena and is conveniently located off of the Southern Tier Expressway and Highway 17 with easy access to Interstate 81 and the Vestal Parkway. La Quinta Inn and Suites by Wyndham at 581 Harry L. Drive, Johnson City. Reach them at 607-770-9333.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Old Vestal Road in Vestal. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Are you kidding me?
How do you do that?
Dude, I just got a new hot spring spa.
Carlisle has hot spring spas starting at $39.95. Come see how we make every day better by relaxing in a hot spring spa.
What happened to you today? You're shredding it.
Hot spring spas, baby.
Welcome back in, everybody. Brooks Hill and Cole Parenti here getting you ready for the second period of tonight's game. These are the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club highlights. Great breakaway save right there from Mack and Animal. Binghamton scores with only a minute 37 left to go in the opening period, Cole. And even though the scoreboard says something pretty different, game is pretty even, I thought, after 20 minutes.
Yeah, both teams seem to come out ready to battle, and Binghamton trying to set a good momentum going into the playoffs. Elmira obviously trying to keep their season alive. Blue Ridge Bobcats not made their job any easier, and we know both these teams play a hard-nosed style of hockey. We'll see if Elmira has something in the tank to come back.
If Elmira was scoreboard watching during that intermission, have to think that they know what they need to do. Cannot let the outcome hold where it is right now.
Yeah, I don't know if they were scoreboard watching or scoreboard looking away, as it was not a pretty sight.
So, second period brought to you by our friends over at Greenlight Networks, fast fiber and reliable internet, as always. Find out if you're in the area of their service by visiting them online at greenlightnetworks.com.
Still not on Long Island?
No, I don't think they've made their way to Long Island yet.
One of these days. You know Tyson Kirkby is going to be crashing that net looking for 40, Brooks. He really wants to get that big 4-0 on the board. Huge accomplishment, not an easy task.
Brant Sherwood joined by JT Walters on the bench. Shot right off the opening draw from Klink. Goes high above the blocker. So Elmira with the first scoring chance of the period. And it comes right off the rip. Now Schultz with plenty of time can settle it down and start the breakout for the River Sharks. No quarter given by the Black Bears D. as they just thwart it right back in towards Sammy Bernard. Goaltender has to get his stick active, and then Schultz deflects it all the way back into the crease. You got to look out there. Good thing Bernard was ready for it.
May still be some growing pains with the big man, number 91, in his new club at Elmira. Still getting used to his new defensive partners. And yes, there are some old teammates there, but still a lot of new ones.
Kirk Bean, just so. Tie up in the faceoff circle. One back by just so. Yarwood able to get the puck to the high winger on the far side. That was Wilson. Meyer starts to make a little progress in getting into the offensive zone and then knocked right back out to the red line. Yarwood crossing over, takes a big hit from Kirkby, and those two getting involved a little bit behind the play. Physicality here, second period, ramping up. Jasso cutting across the line, back over to Yarwood. Arister fought off by McAnanima into the corner. Then Jasso throws a hit towards Dan Stone, knocks him down to the ice. Bond with a hit on Gallieta, lost his stick in the process. Centered out in front, Gallieta denied by McAnanima, right on the doorstep. Out come the Black Bears, back the other way. Clark skates in on the left wing side, pulls the puck into the trapezoid. Then ran into the wall, slowed down his momentum. Black Bears are in the process of a line change. Well, that puck was deep. Now Fitzgerald skates in, playing in his 15th game of the year for the Black Bears. It's been all the final 15 games this season, and he has managed to earn 8 points, 2 goals and 6 assists since rejoining the team, coming off a loan from the Huntsville Havoc. So Anderson reversing it around for his D partner, the aforementioned Fitzgerald. Now Anderson sliding back into the offensive side. Hybrid player, power move to the front, denied by Bernard. Rebound just goes wide of the foot of the Elmira netminder. Fitzgerald dancing around the line. This shot hits a stick on the way through, and it deflects into the net, out of play.
You mentioned Jesse Anderson, a two-way player for the Black Bears, plays forward and defense. My assumption will be that starting playoff time, he's going to be seeing a lot more reps at forward. Such a strong defensive core with Mathieu Boillard returning. The Black Bears have about 7 or 8, I should say, legitimate defensemen. You can't play 8, though, Brooks. You can only play 6 or 7. No JT Walters, no Liam Anderson tonight. And you still have Brody Thornton, too, so that's a 9th.
Yep, everybody for the Black Bears have qualified for the playoffs, as that one is directed into the net once again. Oh, I was waiting for the video to come. It didn't come. The CPR safety net video didn't play.
Maybe after this. Sometimes they play it after.
McAnanima fought that puck off. Back up to Schultz. He holds at the line. Clink, a lot of space. Shot hit the backside of Peavy on the way through. Now Schultz behind the net. Stuff chance denied by McAnanima. Cleaned up by Weber. And the Black Bears elevate that puck out into the neutral zone. Now Utoro chasing in with it. Had it poked off of his stick by Brett Parker. Those two smaller stature bodies get tied up with each other. But we learned last night, Andrew Utoro not afraid to drop the mitts, especially with a guy who's bigger than him. Xavier Abdella definitely in a different weight class and height class than Utoro. But Utoro hold his ground. Logar, a shot snared by Bernard as Binghamton crosses over the blue line and her hang on. 3 minutes and 7 seconds gone here in the middle period.
Seems like the message on the chalkboard from Coach Church was physicality. Elmira finishing their checks. Brooks, that's 0 for 3 right there. Checks as much as they can. And their physicality is going to come into play. They're going to wear the Black Bears down. We'll see if they can keep with it.
Face-off won back by just so good at winning face-offs. Everybody knows him as a skill player for his stick handling and shooting capabilities, but underrated part of his game, draw control as a centerman. Now Yarwood getting the reverse pass from the Elmira center. He's marked by Kirkby, and Kirkby a little bluffing right now on Yarwood, hoping Yarwood makes the first move, and he does. Plays the puck up, and now Gaeta crossing over the middle. Just so shot blocked. This time, it's Dan Stone getting in the way. It's right at the goal line, cleaned up by Stone. And he plays it off the glass and back out towards the blue line. Pickford almost put it into his own net. Bernard had no idea where the puck was. Maybe hit a little puddle in the crease. I don't know. That would have been terrible. Excellent reverse hit by Dan Stone. Sending Gaeta off of the puck. Wilson diving to try to block a pass. Doesn't work out. Thompson scissors it ahead. And Clark impeded on the way through, but we're going to play on here.
Good job by Cam Clark to stay on his feet. Just so strong on those skates.
Again, Elmira puts the puck off of their own goal right in front of the blue paint. Now Jasso out wide. He holds, dancing in on the backhand, scores. Jasso ties the game up at one. 15:28 left to go, and the former Black Bear strikes here in Binghamton.
Well, that was a dirty wrist shot right there from Dustin Jasso. The wrist shot the hardest to pick up for goaltenders. He shelved it right over McAnanima's blocker. Here's another look. He just cuts into the zone. Nobody was able to catch up to him. Backhand shot, tie game. Elmira, Binghamton 1-1.
So both goals coming at even strength. Jasso on the backhand at 4:32 has tied the game up at one. So now we'll see if Elmira can grab some momentum on the bump up shift following the goal. Anderson blows a tire in the corner. It's picked up by Tosto and pushed up to the red line.
So Stephen Klink adds to his Elmira leading point total with another assist there. The secondary, Trevor Newman, got the first. Newman a newcomer but made an impact instantly now with Elmira.
Elmira back into the zone, throwing it towards the net of McAnanima, but it's held on to. Sends us to a media timeout, folks. Elmira ties the game up at one thanks to Dustin Jasso. Back with you after this.
Jersey, bring us the Hennies!
Yeah! All right, I got the Hennies.
That's me, out, eh?
Cheers, baby.
A win like that calls for a real celebration.
Oh, yeah.
Getting your hands on an all-new CF Moto side-by-side or four-wheeler is now easier than ever at ExciteMotorsports.com. Purchase your next power sports vehicle with our new, easy, and quick online buying experience. Browse inventory on ExciteMotorsports.com. Buy, get approved for financing, and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride, have your new power sport vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra charge. Browse, buy, ride. Fun starts here at Excite Motorsports.
Welcome back, everybody. River Sharks tie the game up at one thanks to Jasso's 15th of the season. The assist going to number six, Trevor Newman, his ninth of the year. And Stephen Klink, as Cole mentioned, adds to his team-leading point total. That's his 37th assist of the year. Shot blockered away by McAnanima into the corner. And Elmira trying to look for their first lead of the night. Stefan now picking it off of the half wall. Tried to go wide to Tosto. A little too short on the pass. Leads to a takeaway for Elmira. Klink holding for a shot, looking for the water bottle. And it goes high above the net. Anderson reversing it around for Connor Smith in the corner. Played back up to the line where Powell's waiting for it. Tried a one-timer. He partially fanned on it. Allows Fitzgerald time and space. He backhands one ahead for Stefan and a two-on-one coming back the other way for Elmira. Klink and Newman. Klink holding over to Newman, and Anderson got just enough of it to nullify the scoring chance. Klink now marking Jesse Anderson in the middle of the ice. Anderson holding, senses his team's going for a line change. Does get the puck deep. On the defense is changing. Weber starting and stopping, showing his skating ability. I know the Black Bears don't do team awards, but if there's a player most improved from day one, I think Dan Weber is the runaway favorite.
Agreed.
Weber now pokes that one off the stick and skate of Gaeta, and hit the stick of Gaeta so hard that it ends up behind the net of Binghamton netminder Mackinanima. Get a good look at Matu Boilar, always with his sleeves rolled up. Weaver lost the handle on it. Now Wilson brushed off the puck by Fletcher. Fletcher now ahead for Somro, the 10th forward tonight. You know when Somro's the 10th forward, you got a pretty good lineup. Somro plays it off the wall. Pinching in is Weaver. Cuts into the faceoff circle. Tosto holding, waiting. A shot, save. Bernard, rebound chance denied. Back up towards the blue line. Boilar holding. Wrist shot gloved by Bernard and held on to as Logar and Yarwood and now Jasso get acquainted with each other.
Logar, one of those guys where I loop in Josh Fletcher, two unsung heroes for the Black Bears. There's Fletcher at the bottom of your screen. Those two have done everything right. They give you a hard 60 minutes every night, and Coach Sherwood must love what he's found in Josh Fletcher and Andrew Logar. You see both of them now alongside Justin Somero.
So you see this Heinz Energy replay, a couple of good whacks for the Black Bears just right outside the blue paint. Fletcher won that faceoff and just pushed it forward. Puck held in at the line by Boilar. He has a shot hit by Somero and stick knocked right out of the hands of Logar. And Logar pleading to the official to make the first penalty call of the game, but gonna fall on deaf ears here as Logar skates over towards the Black Bears bench. Wow, look at that 50-50 raffle pot. $1,887.
Is that the highest of the season so far?
On first glance, yes, but cannot confirm or deny that. It just looks big. Now Myra sends this one down the length of the ice, and it's icing. Weaver first to the dot, and he will play the puck for the linesman to come pick up, and Binghamton allowed to choose what faceoff dot they'd like to go to.
Yeah, they'll like to go to the blocker side of Sammy Bernard on Tyson Kirkby's strong side. He's going to look to win that back. I'm sure the puck will try to find its way to Matthew Boilard's slap shot if he can do that.
Jasso still able to win that one back on his offhand. Boilar holds it in at the line, though, on the opposite side. Tipped on by Kirkby. Bernard kicked it out. He was ready for it. Now Clark staying with the pressure against Pickford, and this one is deflected right up top near the press box.
That was a nice catch.
Yeah, that lucky fan's going home with a souvenir. That is the absolute highest I've seen a puck come at the arena. Hold on, I'm going to count the rows. Three rows from where we are here in the press box. And if it was on this end, I was reaching over for it.
And then
monitor and everything.
Falling over if you couldn't get it, but that was a heck of a snag. Let's see if you can see it here. He catches it
on the fly. Tracked it like a fly ball out in center field. What a grab by a lucky fan.
With the beer, he didn't even spill a drop, Brooks.
Now Gignac crossing through the red line into the Binghamton end. He has a shot blocked. Bond got his stick in the way. And Stone plays it up to the wall for Austin Thompson near the blue line. Binghamton could not get it out on first try. It's bouncing around. Clint trying to get it on his forehand, waiting for his defense to get set back up. Clint cuts into the middle using his speed. A shot and a goal. Steven Clint gives Elmira the lead, and the River Sharks up 2-1.
Well, that was a heck of a shot from Mr. Steven Clink. The rookie season marches on as he was named, as you said earlier, Brooks, to the all-rookie team. Beats Mackinanima under the blocker. Let's take another look at it. Just keeps dosey-doing with this puck. Gets himself into a nice shooting area and beats him right under the glove. Nothing Mackinanima could do about that. His defense let him down a little bit, but just a nice play by Clink.
So Clink using his speed to cut into the middle of the ice. And that time able to get one past Mackinanima. Clink's second point of the night. So now Black Bears coming back for more. Bond over to Smith. Bernard made the save. Loose puck right on the goal line and washed away by the officials.
It's days like that, or plays like that, I should say. I wish we had a camera right there in the goal. I'd love to see how close that came from crossing the line. This is the closest we're going to get as it bounced behind Bernard and everyone converged. I don't know how that one stayed out. Some puck luck on the Sharks' side.
So Binghamton following up the Elmira goal with a high danger opportunity of their own. We have a little altercation between Jake Schultz and Connor Smith. And we're going to have the game's first penalties right here.
Yep, they're both going to take a seat, so we'll see if this is going to be 4-on-4 or 5-on-5. Now, something to note, Brooks, it was before the puck is dropped. I don't know if that's a bigger consequence or not, but those two going to take a seat. Now, it looks like just 2 minutes going to go up on the board for Smith and Schultz.
8:39, time of the penalty.
Oh, the puck was down. My bad, Brooks. Smith kind of laughing at Schultz as they went off. Each going to be in the sin bin 2 minutes. And I've always said this benefits the Black Bears with guys like Gavin Yates and Cam Clark. No Gavin Yates tonight for the 4-on-4, but Cam Clark much in the lineup. He'll start on the bench, but he's one of those guys that's crafty with that extra ice.
So now Elmira with the lead. Take a player off of the ice on each side. So Schultz gets unsportsmanlike, and I have to imagine that Connor Smith is going to get the same thing. And it is. So neither side getting a man advantage here. It is the game's first two penalties, though, by letter of the law. Stone holding at the line, plays it over for Bond, and he picked his head up at the last second. Still able to get a good shot off. With some traffic, and Bernard makes the save.
Yeah, if Bond could have got his handle on that, it would have been a heck of a shot from the 16-goal scorer on the Black Bears. Been a heck of a rookie campaign for Mr. Dakota Bond, coming over late from the Roanoke Rail Yard Dogs, who won their game yesterday, Brooks. So Brendan Stanko and the Roanoke Rail Yard Dogs stay alive for game three tonight. But back to Bond, he's been everything the Black Bears could have asked for and much, much more. Now it's played low for Fitzgerald. He'll dance with it by the goal line.
Yeah, he's got Thompson camped out right in front, using the defender as a little bit of a screen. Fortunately, that defender deflected the puck back up towards the top of the zone. Kirkby applying pressure, and it's skated out of harm's way by Elmira. So now Yarwood cuts in front of his own bench. Good wrap check by the captain, being Kirkby, to play it over to Fitzgerald with plenty of space. Anderson gets past Klink, now skates into the zone, dropping it back for Thompson. Just at the dots, a shot hit the stick of Pickford, and back to the other side. Parker, along with Klink, crosses over. Binghamton doesn't believe it. They thought that play was offsides, and now knocked down by Mackinanimal, and then there's going to be some rough stuff in front. Pickford with a whack on Mackinanimal. That's going to definitely stir the pot.
Looks like we'll have to discuss it after the media timeout, but Mackinanimal got right into Pickford's face. Don't see the goalies getting into it very much, Brooks. Here it is again. Klink coming across. Sorry, Parker coming across. That shot gets there eventually. An extra whack there from Pickford. Everyone takes exception, including Mackinanimal. Sorry, Mr. Pickford, but he's wearing a lot of pads. That's not going to do much if you give him a bit of a shot there.
So Pickford gets a two-minute penalty. And that sends us to a media timeout. We'll tell you all about it when we come back.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Upper Front Street in Binghamton. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Go Black Bears. Welcome back, everybody. Austin Pickford sitting down in the box for 2 minutes for that little altercation and a couple of whacks on Connor Mack and Anima. Apologies for that. The A10 mixer has come unplugged.
As this one's won back now here. Bond across. Kirkby shot high and wide. That's going to bounce out of play. A beautiful opportunity for Tyson Kirkby to even this game up and find his 40th of the season goes for naught, as it looks like we should be back up and running.
Sorry about that, everybody. You didn't miss much.
But they'll set up to Sandy Bernard's glove side.
Sorry about that. Electrical plug came out of the socket. Speaking of spark plug, Dakota Bond wanting to fire one and jumpstart this Binghamton offense. He holds. And we'll play it over. Orlogar Bond across to Kirkby. One-timer denied by Bernard. Bernard, sensing the one-timer was coming, already cheating over. And this is a 4-on-3. Now making it a 5-on-4. Ahead for Kirkby. Logar skates in. Power move. Tried to go through the 5-hole. And Bernard closed the door. Kirkby centering it back up for Bond. Smith, one-timer blast save made by the Elmira goalie. 9:07 left to go.
Good job by Bernard to get across. A great power move from Logar, but Black Bears still down by one.
So Binghamton will change. Tosto, Logar, Thompson, along with Kirkby now as Smith makes his way off the ice.
As Neon Trees rings through the arena, you know they're coming to Binghamton University in a couple weeks, Brooks.
Okay. So now Tosto playing it over for Logar, holding the blue line. This is a traditional 5-on-4 Henny Hard-Seltzer power play for the Black Bears. First man advantage of the game. They got a minute. Schultz able to throw this one down the length of the ice as Bond shot from the point was deflected. Elmira trying to win in Binghamton for the first time in FPHL history. The Mammoth.
And Bernard had to go right off his pads and into the glove. A great job of tracking the puck there by the big man in net.
Blink 182 now ringing throughout the arena, trying to get the crowd involved.
They are not coming to Binghamton University.
That is correct. 33 seconds left to go in the power play. Stone shot, a one-timer deflected by an Elmira stick. Stephen Kling got his twig on that one. Cam Clark playing it off the wall, back up to Stone at the point. One-timer from Boylar, steered aside by Bernard. Boylar and Bernard say that five times fast. 8 minutes left to go here in the period. Looks like the penalty time will expire. Binghamton will go 0-for-1 on the power play here tonight. Pickford back out onto the ice. Clark cuts in towards the middle. He holds a shot off of the body of Asp. Played back out towards the line. It's held in temporarily by Connor Smith. Binghamton trying to keep it in the offensive side. They do not. This is a delayed offsides. Clark gets the memo, and he has to retreat. Big hit by Utoro. Flying the body around, then Asp had a hit for Stefan right outside the curved glass. Always got to look out for that. Remember, Dan Weber laid that hit on an Elmira player right at that curved glass, and Elmira definitely took exception to that. Wilson crossing over, sidestepping a hip check from Weber, and Mackinanima just decides to melt it down with 7:08 left to go here in the period.
Yep, Mackinanima looking strong again. Seen 17 shots, stopped 15. But Sammy Bernard on the other side, 27 shots, only allowing one goal. He is going to be key for the Elmira if they want to make it to the playoffs and keep going. You always need a strong goaltender. Goaltenders can steal you games, but also going to be important for Elmira is this defense, because defense wins series.
Fletcher wins this faceoff back to Weber. He cuts in front of his own net and will play it on the backhand out wide for Logar to chase after it. Elmira, though, first team to the puck is Yarwood. Tries a little give-and-go action with Gaeta. Now Jasso crossing over the line with the puck. Tried to get the puck on the backhand once again. That time it rolled off his tape And back over to Dan Weber. Black Bears reclaim control. Utoro now skates in. He's got a step and then knocked down to the ice by Pickford. And a penalty here is called against Elmira. Holding is the indication. And now Pickford's trying to take Utoro with him. And Utoro, smarter, is going to skate away from the altercation.
Well, it was a smart move by Fletcher there. He was looking to come help his teammate out, but once he saw that there was a penalty, he didn't want to give it back. So we just stood and kind of gave him a little bit of lip service. Not going to get you time in the box for that as the Black Bears get to set up on their second power play of the night. Here's the penalty. It's a hold on Pickford. He'll take a seat. And now Binghamton needing to get themselves in a position here to tie this one up going into the tunnel. Six to go.
Second Henny hard seltzer power play of the night for the Black Bears. 5-on-4. Face off. One back to the blue line for Dakota Bond. Gets it over to Logar. Power move, poked wide. Big cross check out in front from Schultz on Thompson. Those two have been going at it with each other all night long. Thompson, though, goes right back to the blue paint, gets to his spot. He's drawing the attention of Jake Schultz so much right now. Tosto takes the hit from Schultz, gets the puck over to Kirkby. Cross-size pass now for Logar. He spins around. Cuts in and just through the blue paint and out. Big collision at the blue paint again. Austin Thompson knocked down by Schultz, gets right back up. Looks at the referee for a call, but none provided here. 45 seconds gone on the Henny hard seltzer power play. Now Bond through the middle of the ice. It hit a stick on the way through. Works out for the Black Bears, though. Kirkby will settle it down. First minute of the power play is gone, and the first unit still out there. Bond fans on a wrister, still able to get it deep. Schultz tries to elevate it out of the zone, held in at the line by Binghamton. Bond now over to Tosto, return feed to the doorstep. Kirkby, loose puck, they still whack at it, cleaned up by Elmira. And Thompson and Powell involved behind the play. Parker now taking up precious seconds of the man advantage. They go to Asp, Klink all alone, shorthanded, sent it wide. 20 seconds left to go in the power play for Binghamton. Second unit starting to make their way onto the ice. Bond at the end of his shift gets it over to Tosto. Has more energy left in the tank. Now Thompson dropping it back for Logar. Holding, loose puck. Clark across looking for Thompson on the one touch. Hit a stick on the way through. Pickford up and ready. And the door opens. He has returned. Binghamton 0-for-2 on the man advantage so far tonight. Came into the night leading the FPHL at 29% with 80 power play strikes. Asp now directs it off the wall and Fitzgerald. Follows it up himself, tries to get it deep, but instead, Stefan picks it out. Second line onto the ice now for the Black Bears as the first unit played that entire 2 minutes. For Binghamton on the Henny hard seltzer power play, Gaeta. Cutting across the red and now the blue line. Throwing up the ice. Hits the man behind the play. Fought off by Mackinanima. Wilson's one-timer. Denied by the Black Bears goaltender. 19th shot of the night for Elmira. Binghamton with 31. Stefan, one-on-two. Just steers it ahead on the backhand for Powell. He's waiting for the loose puck. Takes a nudge from Smith. And Gaeta now into the middle of the ice for Gesso. Almost put his team off signs, but they stay on and poked away by Fletcher with a stick in the passing lane.
Great back check by Fletcher to break that one up, keeping the Black Bears, who seem to be on their toes right now, in a chance to get this puck out.
Newman tried to come away with the one-time feed to Gesso. He was knocked down, and Josh Fletcher is going to cut through the middle of the ice. High backhanded, elevated out to the middle. Where Pickford couldn't corral it. Somro skating away with it. Fletcher picks up the loose puck. Steers on the backhand. Utoro one-timer bid denied. Loose puck still available. And finally, the play is blown dead. And then Pickford behind the play with a late shove. Linesman getting in between this one. And the referee behind the play off of your screen pointing his finger at somebody.
He's got his hand on his hip, too. Look at him. That's someone who's seen enough. I think it's Pickford who's going to buy himself another trip to the box. Was involved with Jesse Anderson behind the play. But we'll find out when we get back, Brooks.
Take a timeout. Elmira up 2-1. Back with you after this.
Fans, some exciting news. The next Black Bears home game will be round one of the Commissioner's Cup playoffs. And to celebrate the occasion, the Black Bears are offering $5 select 16-ounce beers on the concourse while supplies last. Grab your tickets now at BinghamtonBlackBears.com, and we can't wait to see you for the playoffs.
Should I get a COVID vaccine? I have concerns.
Are there still health risks associated with COVID if I don't get a vaccine?
Does getting the vaccine protect others around me?
The answer is yes. Getting the COVID vaccine protects you from serious illness and those around you that you may expose, especially those with certain health issues. Ask your healthcare professional about your concerns and the easiest way for you to get a vaccine. Remember, it's not just COVID.
Oh, the bird, you make me think of good things.
Good day.
Like calming tempers down.
Good day.
Good-natured Canadian Pilsner.
So Austin Pickford getting real familiar with the penalty box here in the second period. That's his third penalty of the frame. And I don't know if we're going to have the best angle on it. It'll be at the third of your screen right here behind the play. Oh, there we go. Top left right here. And that extra rack right there. That's what got him.
Yeah, it's always those extra ones, but Josh Fletcher are going to be taking a seat with him as he took exception to Pickford's move there.
Elmira penalty number 4, Austin Pickford, 2 minutes for roughing.
So Pickford gets two for roughing. Roughing, cross-checking, whichever way floats your boat. And Josh Fletcher gets 2 minutes for roughing as well. So it looks like neither side gains an advantage. We're at 4-on-4. 17:03, time of both of those penalties. So matching roughings. Open up the ice a little bit. Gaeta chasing after it. Steered all the way around the wall by McAnanima. Schultz overskated the puck, and that leads Weber to go 1-on-1. See what he can cook up against Just So. Nifty move by Weber. He's on the backhand. Spinning around, looking for Kirkby. Back up to Thompson. It ricocheted, and then a big pile up in front of the net.
It was Weber and Boylard who had jumped up on the rush, leaving the two forwards of Kirkby and Thompson in the back end. So a bit of a reverse kind of for the Black Bears. Weber's shown he's more than capable of handling the puck. Here it is again. This one comes right out to Thompson. It was manning the blue line. And Sammy Bernard up to the task because that one gets him right in the pads.
So now Brett Parker crossing over. And nope, check that. Klink was already offside, so Parker pulls back. 1 minute left to go, 4-on-4. 2 minutes left to go here in the second period. Elmira with a one-goal lead. Just So and Klink with the goals here in the middle frame. Yarwood pulls it out of the corner. Gaeta over to Klink. One-timer through the five hole. He scores.
Well, it's still just So and Klink with the goals, but now Stephen Klink with his second of the game. And big players show up in big spots. That's exactly what Stephen Klink's doing here, 4-on-4. Elmira opens their lead up 3-1. Unfamiliar territory for the Black Bears. Haven't really been down in this arena, especially down by multiple goals. We'll see if they can respond or if Elmira can cruise themselves into a Commissioner Cup playoff spot and clinch it tonight.
So a 4-on-4 goal for Stephen Klink. Still counts as an even strength goal, but make a note of it. That's a special teams goal here for Elmira. Giniak and Yarwood. The assist on the Stephen Klink goal, and now the Black Bears find themselves down by a pair. Stone leaving it back for Connor Smith, another stretch opportunity here. Clink is on sides, waiting for reinforcements. He holds. A little drag shot. Mack and Animal makes the save.
Black Bears have to make sure the puck keeps going north. They got to get one before they can get two, so they can't allow odd man rushes to come back the other way, just like they did there.
Trying to win it right back to just so this time. Somero skates away with the loose puck off the faceoff win from Clark. Big hit elevated on Justin Somero by Jake Schultz, and Josh Fletcher is going to go for him. Josh Fletcher stepping right over to Jake Schultz, not afraid of it at all.
What once was a fan favorite sure endeared himself in a negative way to these fans tonight, as Elise Wilbur is checking on Justin Somero. A high hit there from Jake Schultz. It'll be interesting to see what comes of this.
So Fletcher and Somero both go immediately to the locker room. Jake Schultz goes to the Elmira door as well.
Unsure if with Fletcher if it's going to be because he may have injured himself or because, as Schultz leaves his feet there, that's not a good play there from the veteran, former captain of the Black Bears. He should know better than that. That's really all I can say about that, but we'll see if Fletcher goes back to the tunnel because of his five-minute fighting major or because he got himself a little banged up. Wasn't much of a scrap that got off because Fletcher kind of got off balance as soon as the gloves went down. So I don't really think anyone won that one.
Fletcher just standing up for his teammate saying that's not going to fly.
Here's the hit one more time. You see that elbow make contact with Somero's head. Now, to play both sides, devil's advocate, Somero was kind of slanted down a bit as he was skating, but I don't think that hit has a place in hockey. Brooks, what do you think?
I think the Black Bears have a case for being upset that nothing was called. We'll leave it at that. So Jake Schultz gets five for fighting in a 10-minute misconduct as well. Josh Fletcher will also get five for fighting as to match. So 30 seconds left to go here. Elmira has scored three goals here in the middle frame. Binghamton not able to find the net. 20 seconds left to go in the period. We skate 5-on-5. Anderson out wide, and that puck will be deflected into the crowd and out of play.
12 seconds left here. The Black Bear is going to get a neutral zone faceoff near their intended target. We'll see if they can get one last rush at Sammy Bernard or if Elmira will skate off with a two-goal lead into the third period.
Tosto gets it in down low for Connor Smith. Final chance for the Black Bears. Throws it towards the net. 3 seconds left. Fitzgerald trying to settle it down. Doesn't deflect near the pegs. And that is the end of the second period. Game really flipping up on its head. Elmira leads by two after two full periods of play.
Yeah, and Elmira, knowing what they're playing for, they came for that 3 points, and there's still a whole period they have to get through to ensure it, but looking good right now are the Elmira River Sharks, and I'm sure that was because of what they saw from Watertown's game down in the Blue Ridge Mountains.
probably going to have an exciting finish here in this one. Watertown playing for their season. Binghamton trying to send the hometown faithful with a big comeback victory. We're taking a timeout. Come back with more right after this. Excite Motorsports Intermission Report coming up.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet, so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
For discounted name brand clothing and footwear for the whole family, Homer Men and Boys Store is the place to shop. In business since 1951, our woman-owned family business is known for treating their customers like family. And there's nothing more important to us than backing every sale with friendly service. Come visit us to see the largest pair of jeans in the world. Come see what we have for you.
Well, we want to make sure not to cut away from this. Glenn Pitcher from our friends over at 98.1 The Hawk. MCing the Chuck-a-Puck all year long. And somebody's going home with a brand new ATV tonight, Cole.
Yeah, I'm excited to watch here, Brooks. Seven finalists. This is sure to be a fiery finish. I'm invested, Brooks.
So let's go ahead and take a look at the Columbia Mutual Life Insurance stat sheet. Columbia Mutual Life Insurance Company been protecting families in the Southern Tier for over 140 years. Binghamton in that second period able to get 19 shots on goal. However, they don't find the back of the net. Binghamton game total of 35. Elmira able to put 13 shots up in the frame. Three of them find the back of the net. And Elmira now leads by two.
Yeah, and as we always say, Brooks, it doesn't matter how many shots you put up on goal. All that matters is how many touch the back of the net. And for Elmira, it was three in that period. Oh, here we go. First key, Brooks. I have my money on the guy in the flannel, Brooks. I don't know why.
I think that guy was a finalist last year.
The guy in the flannel or the guy in the Mark Stone jersey?
The guy in the Mark Stone jersey. Got to be Bobby's favorite player or contestant right now.
Mark Stone's going to be ready to go for game one, right?
That's what some people are saying. Bobby doesn't believe it.
It's a
our resident Vegas fan. All right, 0 for 2 so far, and it's 0 for 3. So everybody who's left has a 20% chance of going home with the ATV here tonight.
Here's my guy. I'm thinking this is it, Brooks.
Okay. It does. Wait. Okay. Cole was right. The man in the flannel going home with a brand new CF Moto, courtesy of our friends over at Excite Motorsports. What a time to be alive.
How do you get that home? You got to drive it on the roads? Does it come with its own little...
I bet they deliver it. They have free next-day delivery to New York and Pennsylvania.
I'm sure that's burning your brain after saying it all season.
Yeah, you can visit them online anytime at ExciteMotorsports.com. And fan appreciation night going well here tonight. We just gave away a brand new CF Moto.
Third straight year giving it away. It's been a heck of a promotion. It's fun to watch. And Brooks, I had a feeling I knew he was going to win. I don't know what it was, Brooks.
All right, let's see if you can have some more predictions come true later on here tonight. We're going to take a timeout, come back with more after these messages.
Roman Acres Veterinary Hospital is proud to announce they are now offering urgent care visits from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Sundays beginning April 7th. This service is open for both clients and non-clients alike. If your pet is sick and your primary care vet isn't open, give them a call at 607-656-4285 or visit RomanAcresVet.com for more information.
Are you ready to take your billiards game to a whole new level? Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop has everything you need to impress your friends and crush your opponents. American Q Sports certified coach Kim the Dragon Young is now accepting new students. From novices to pros, the Dragon helps you find your best game with in-person or online instruction available worldwide. Need help with stance, stroke, or alignment and aiming? We've got you covered. Looking for advanced cue control techniques and trick shots? No problem. Follow us on Facebook at Dragon Billiards Instruction and Instagram at Dragon Billiards Kim for free daily tips and drills, upcoming tournaments and events, as well as exciting contests and giveaways. Subscribe on Patreon for personalized video content. Visit our online pro shop for the lowest prices on the highest quality pool cues, accessories, and Dragon Billiards gear. Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop, breathing fire into your game.
When you care about something, you take care to protect it. The family that depends on you and the future you're planning for them.
You'll have your own college stories too someday.
With sound advice, smart strategies, and a broad variety of life insurance options, Security Mutual can help provide for the people you care about and also help you reach your financial goals.
It's a sound plan. The time to start thinking about college
and retirement is now.
Security Mutual Life, the company that cares.
Get access to exclusive player events, monthly parties, and road trips to away Black Bears games. This is what you get when you become a member of the Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Stop by the Booster Club table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game, pick up a 50-50 ticket, and sign up to join for just $10. Stay up to date on the Booster Club by liking their Facebook page, facebook.com/Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Monthly meetings with players, road trips, and a whole lot of fun when you join the Black Bears Booster Club.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Upper Front Street in Binghamton. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet, so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Welcome back, everybody. 9 minutes, 30 seconds left to go here in the second period. We've already given away an ATV and thrown some t-shirts into the stands as well. So that means the only logical next thing we can do is talk about what's going on across the FPHL. So, Cole, why don't you give everybody at home on YouTube an update for us on the out-of-town scoreboard.
Yep, and Motor City's jumped out to a 6-2 lead over the Port Huron Prowlers. That game's pretty close to going final. They should be in about the second half of their third period. Watertown, we saw them go up 3-0 last time in the first period. The second period, Withville gets one back. It's 3-1. Still Watertown, but the Blue Ridge Bobcats are on the board. Columbus extends their lead over Carolina 6-1. While Baton Rouge gets off to a hot start versus the Seawolves, they lead 2-0 there. So one more time in Fraser, Motor City over Port Huron 6-2. Blue Ridge Mountain has the Wolves leading 3-1 over the Bobcats. Down in Georgia, 6-1, River Dragons over Thunderbirds. And in Baton Rouge, 2-0, Zydeco over the Seawolves.
Thank you, Cole. That's a look at our out-of-town scoreboard across the FPHL, the game of most importance being the Watertown-Blue Ridge game for Elmira. Watertown with a two-goal lead like the River Sharks have over the Black Bears right now. We're taking a timeout, come back, get you ready for the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club highlights getting into the third period, and we'll also get Cole's thoughts on what the Black Bears need to do to get back into this one. Back with you after this, folks. More coming up on the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report.
Whether you're a high school or college athlete or a weekend warrior, Guthrie is the area's premier sports medicine program, offering injury evaluation, concussion management, physical therapy, and more. With a full team of providers across New York and Pennsylvania offering same or next day appointments, Guthrie gets you back in the game as quickly as possible. Call the Guthrie Sports Medicine team today at 866-GUTHRIE or learn more at guthrie.org/sportsmed.
Are you looking for a new place to live? Lofts at JC is the official housing partner of the Binghamton Black Bears and the only luxury housing provider offering both 2 and 3 bedroom units fully furnished for a modern living lifestyle. Lofts at JC is centrally located in the heart of the Tri-Cities area, located at 128 Grand Avenue in Johnson City. Housing applications are accepted online at loftsatjc.com. Once again, that's loftsatjc.com.
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Jersey, bring us the hitties! Yeah!
All right, I got the hitties.
That's me out, eh?
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah. Cheers, baby.
Win like that calls for a real celebration.
Oh, yeah.
Magic 101.7.
The best radio station. Keeps getting better.
Better music selection.
Best ever. Makes me feel better.
Number one for music and fun.
It's like the best ever.
Magic 101.7. 100% local.
Getting your hands on an all-new CF Moto side-by-side or four-wheeler is now easier than ever at ExciteMotorsports.com. Purchase your next power sports vehicle with our new, easy, and quick online buying experience. Browse inventory on ExciteMotorsports.com. Buy, get approved for financing, and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride, have your new power sports vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra charge. Browse, buy, ride. Fun starts here at ExciteMotorsports.com.
Experience the new way to watch your Black Bears play all season long at home and on the road, free on YouTube.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
Welcome back, everybody. Getting you ready for tonight's third period, brought to you by BJ's Wholesale Club. Black Bears find themselves down by a pair, and special teams not paving the way for Binghamton tonight. Their lone goal comes at even strength back at the 18:23 mark of the opening period. Elmira, all three of their goals are even strength technically, but the second Stephen Klink goal of the night was 4-on-4. Binghamton is 0-for-2 on the power play tonight.
Yeah, and power play has been the strongest thing for the Black Bears all season, so they need to make sure they can keep up the pace and keep that power play to where it's been in an elite. It's number one on the league, so they got to make sure to keep it up and keep pucks firing at the net if they get another chance.
So getting ready to cue up the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club highlights here, taking us through the second period into the third for tonight. Elmira already waiting by the door. They're trying to make their way out onto the ice as soon as the door opens up. So, according to the league website, the Schultz misconduct is just a 10-minute misconduct, not a game misconduct. So I would imagine that they put Schultz and Fletcher right back into the penalty box to start tonight's third period.
Yeah, and we'll have to look to see to make sure Justin Somero and Fletcher come out for the third period. Somero obviously took that heavy hit. Fletcher, we didn't really see much of him. Didn't really get that fight off the ground, but he kind of got off balance, and that's always dangerous for him.
So here are the highlights brought to you by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. They're going to get you ready for tonight's third period. Well, some good news. Josh Fletcher seems to be okay. He's sitting in the penalty box right now. Taking a peek over for Justin Somero on the Black Bears bench. Do not see anything quite yet.
We don't really have the best view of the Black Bears bench, though, Brooks. A lot of numbers blocked, so hopefully number 10 is sitting down there and getting ready for his next shift. No Schultz in the box either, Brooks.
A little strange. Oh, getting ready to put. And there's Justin Somero sitting right there on the bench. Excellent job by our video team, as always. Big thanks to those guys who have been putting in a lot of work all season long, not only at home, but answering the phone when I have questions on the road and helping me out. Josh Williams and his entire team do an excellent job as always.
Big sigh of relief to see Justin Somero sitting on that bench. Was nervous when he went to the locker room, and now we can put those fears to bed as he's returned. And I'm sure he's going to be looking to get some revenge in the form of putting the puck in the back of the net.
So tonight's third period, always brought to you by our friends over at the BJ's Wholesale Club. You can visit them in Johnson City over at the Oakdale Commons. Sign up and save up to 25% off grocery store prices every day.
So, and they have cheap gas.
Yep, I mean, you beat me to it.
I've heard you say it enough times.
Well, I'm glad someone's listening. So Elmira does not have a player in the penalty box. A little peculiar to me, but we'll work with the off-ice officials and see if we get an explanation maybe during one of our TV timeouts.
The only thing I could think of is that Fletcher's penalty is going to end before Schultz's, and maybe they don't want Fletcher and Schultz in the box next to each other jawing. It's the only thing that could ring to mind. Or Schultz might be getting some repairs.
So now Wilson playing it across the line for just so fresh ice. It rolled off of his stick. Goes for a swim move like a lacrosse player. Taking a hand off of his stick. Nice little deke from just so as Fitzgerald gets a bump in the neutral zone. Binghamton plays the puck off the wall to the far side. Smith takes the nudge from just so and reverse around to the half wall. Stefan able to get his stick to it. And then a funny bounce off of the corner dasher. Allows Elmira the opportunity to catch their breath as they get this puck out. Jasso now, his shot between the legs of Fitzgerald, played back up to the blue line. Big collision right at the bench. Couple of bodies tied up. We have a penalty coming up. You try to get a look at it. Got some players looking over each other. The linesman intervening. Getting between the two sides. Don't know who's at the bottom of that pile.
I believe it was Fitzgerald who took the first hit. It looks like, yeah, someone's at the bottom of the pile. We don't know. Powell came over after Smith took exception to it. And I'm going to guess it's Boylard as he takes a seat in the box.
I think that's actually Kyle Stefan.
Oh, yeah, you're right, Brooke. Sorry, I saw the two on the back of the jersey. Yeah, it's Stefan who took exception. There's the hit right there, just a clean hit. Is that just so? I can only see one number.
Yes,
it's
just so.
Oh, he's going to sit in the box, so yep, it's just so.
So 20 and 22 sitting down for the respective clubs. Both of these penalties at 145.
So the video room has let us know that Schultz can't come back till about 5:55 is what they're saying, Brooks.
Okay. Thank you, video team. So Jesso gets two for charging. So we're back to 4-on-4 as Kyle Stefan also gets a penalty as well for cross-checking. So Elmira has a 4-on-4 goal here tonight. Can Binghamton get one here and cut the lead in half? Fitzgerald flies by, gets past Klink. Skates in from the dots, holding back across a one-timer. Bernard made the save on Kirkby.
As he looks up to the heavens, he wants that 40, but a beautiful pass there from Austin Thompson to find Kirkby. Here it is again. Fitzgerald, we know, is a smooth-moving puck defenseman. Gets to Thompson. One more pass, and Sammy Bernard stands tall. Kirkby can't get that 40th goal. He's trying so hard.
Kirk, keep at it. Powell tries to pin the puck up against the wall. He does get it back to Asp. And now Newman ahead for Gallego. One-on-one, poked away by Weber. Clark getting it around Powell. Skate to stick. Smith holding. Tries a stuff chance. It pinballs around off a couple of skates, and now Powell skates away with the puck. So just so correction on his penalty, it's actually a boarding, not a charge. Still counts the same. And Smith settles it down. 45 seconds left to go. And 4-on-4 hockey. Weber handcuffed a little bit. Gaeta tries to take a nudge at Smith, but Smith is going to stand up tall right there. Now now Cam Clark crosses over the line, one on two. He throws one towards the net, fought off by Bernard, couldn't be held on to. Yarwood to the open ice at the red line. Tosta was coming on for a change. 15 seconds left to go. It's fan bases going back and forth with each other. Big collision just inside the blue line. Kicked ahead by Bond. He settles it. He's coming in on the backhand over to Logar. Rebound. Save made by Bernard off of Tosto. Dan Stone starting the cycle for the Black Bears now. 5-on-5. Open ice. Bond. Shot on the forehand. Just misses on the blocker side. No bodies flying here in the third period. Stone gets it over. The Stefan, a shot, scores! Kyle Stefan continues his hot streak, and the Black Bears right back in this one.
Raise the rally chair, Brooks. What a move from Kyle Stefan. Gets himself right into the slot, and he finishes the play. Gets the Black Bears to within one, and oh, did they need that as they look to be energized once again. Just came out of the box after his penalty was up. Cuts into the slot, inside out, says thank you very much. And the Black Bears only trail by one.
So Kyle Stefan, his eighth of the year, and just so, headed right back to the penalty box. So Binghamton looks like they could be headed to the power play. Then a little extra whack from Jasso.
Are you balancing that chair on your head?
I am.
I thought, whoa.
Oh, party foul.
Come on, Dustin. There's other people going to have to use that water bottle. And poor Frank Kearney is in the splash zone.
I know. Crazy. So it looks like we're staying 5-on-5.
Wait to see what happened from Frank Perney.
Stretch pass over to Utoro. Binghamton looking for the equalizer, not going to find it there. Somro back out onto the ice. Love to see that from the 10th forward. Utoro shot, snared by Bernard. So Stone and Bond getting the helpers. That is an even strength 5-on-5 goal because, remember, Stefan was sitting in the penalty box.
Yep, him and Jesso had come out of the box. And the Adrian College Bulldogs chip in again. Both Stone and Bond getting themselves some assists. And Dakota Bond's been sensational.
So Josh Fletcher gets out of the penalty box, and he's got some barking words for Jesso, who's still sitting down.
Huge ovation from the crowd, rightfully so, for Josh Fletcher after coming up meeting the task.
So, we'll see how good this ending gets. Stop chance, Kirkby sends it high off the rebound. Loose puck, trapped by Bernard, sensing momentum shifting back towards the Black Bears.
Yeah, it sounds like he got abusive official is what got Jesso a nice minute in the box. And the Black Bears look like they have some momentum going, Brooks.
Let's see if Elmira can weather the storm. Kirkby tries to win it back to the forward on the left wing side. Nobody home. Clink out wide, a drag shot. Goes wide of the target. Played back behind the net. See if Elmira can have a good bump up shift here after the Black Bears have had a little bit of momentum. Self pass, Clark to Clark. Dropping it back. Now fought off from a low angle by Bernard, by Jesse Anderson, and he's going to trap that one down too. Yep. 4:56 left to go here. Third period. Don't go anywhere. More coming up right after this.
When you care about something, you take care to protect it. The family that depends on you and the future you're planning for them.
You'll have your own college stories too someday.
With sound advice, smart strategies, and a broad variety of life insurance options, Security Mutual can help provide for the people you care about and also help you reach your financial goals.
It's a sound plan. The time to start thinking about college
and retirement is now.
Security Mutual Life, the company that cares.
Welcome back inside Visions Veteran Memorial Arena. Cole Parenti, Brooks Hill with you. A fiery game, to say the least. The Black Bears have just cut the deficit to one, and now they'll look to get the equalizer with a face-off to Sammy Bernard's glove side.
So they send Kyle Steffen back out there to take the face-off. Crowd is coming alive here. I thought I had the crowd mic off. It's coming through my microphone.
Big crowd on hand too, Brooks.
Still waiting to get that final number from our good friends, Trevor and Bobby. Shot thrown on, loose puck, they score! Tied game, once again! Black Bears capture all the momentum in the world. Tip of the hat from the Cowboy, Connor Smith.
Connor Smith gets the equalizer here, and there you go, Brooks, throwing the rally. The rally chair in the air. Let's take another look. Face-off one back. First shot mishandled by Bernard. And the Cowboy finishes what was started by Kyle Steffen. Black Bears get this one tied. And, oh, Brooks, plenty of time and momentum going their way.
So, 15 minutes left to go. We are all even. Elmira fighting for their lives. Now in a dogfight. Connor Smith gets the goal. Now looking for more. Toe drag shot, tipped just high above the net. Anderson in and out of the glove on the one-timer of Bernard. Crowd is into it, so am I. Boy, Larnell holding for a wrist shot blocked by Newman. Binghamton starting the cycle. Smith holding cross ice for Anderson, feathered ahead, and Bernard desperately wants a whistle. Hero hang on.
Smartly done by Bernard. Jesse Anderson with a great pinch in the play there, trying to jump up but was able to get back quick before anything could go wrong there. So great job by Anderson to get himself a part of it into the play.
My arms are tired.
It's a workout, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
If they score the next one, I'll do it with you.
Puck back in play and taken right back by the Black Bears. Two on one. Fletcher holding. Blockered away into the net. Elmira calling for the whistle. They didn't get it from the linesman or the referee. So Kling just throws it in and we play on. Everybody for Elmira kind of stopped playing for a second. Now Gaeta playing it back up to the line. A wrist shot off the glass and around the wall to the blue line. Held in temporarily by Gaeta. And now Fletcher picks up his steam. Across, Boylar, he's holding on to it, throws it towards the net, loose puck! Somero hit the post! Now the River Sharks could have numbers, two on one. Klink fumbled with it in his skates. They would have been offsides, and in fact they are. 13-18 left to go.
And wouldn't that have been great for Justin Somero to get this one tied up? Excuse me, give the Black Bears the lead, it's already tied up. Where have I been for the last 5 minutes? Here he is again on the doorstep. Just some fumbling and bumbling. Couldn't get that one to go. I'm sure Somero wants that back, but really nothing he can do there as two River Sharks close down on him.
I think my shirt came untucked a little bit during that celebration.
You wearing a belt?
Not tonight. Faceoff pushed back all the way into the Elmira end by Kirkby. We told you it was going to be a good finish. We got 13 minutes here to decide a winner. Maybe need some more. Now Clark, all the way ahead, up to the blue line. Thompson corrals it, lost his edge, nothing there, gets it over to Kirkby. Back up to the line for Stone, has the assist on the Kyle Steffen goal that made it 3-2. Elmira tries to clear, it's held in by the Black Bears again. Thompson now at the goal line for the captain down low, give and go, back up to Stone off his skate. Elmira tries to get it out, but it's held in by Clark. Clark goes off for a change. Nice little spin move by Bond on Parker, but lost control of the puck in the process. Elmira does get the puck out. Newman holding for a drag shot, blocked by Bond. That one goes off the skate. Kirkby giving a nudge to Powell, gets outside the blue line, so Elmira's going to have to touch up. Very exciting way to finish the season here, wouldn't you say, Cole?
To say the least, Brooks, it was an exciting start against these River Sharks back in game one, and we would expect nothing less after watching the next 55 that would conclude.
Smith going back across for Tosto in his skates. Clink over to the loose puck, tries a self-pass off the wall to get around Anderson. Nobody there as Clink and Anderson get tied up with each other. Elmira's on delayed offsides. Clink can't touch it. That gives Anderson some more time behind his own net to take a breath. Now Stefan continues to impress, takes the hit. Gets the puck down low though. Stefan trying to play from the ground. Nothing there. Wilson wants a call, none provided. Binghamton swarming the puck in that Elmira corner, but the River Sharks finally able to get it out to Clink. Give and go with Newman, holding for a shot, kicked out by Mackinanima. Fitzgerald to the rebound, has some space in front. Gets up to the red line, though, and would just slide it down the ice on the same side while his team is changing.
Now Samaro's going to chase after, and he's been a ball of energy to start this period. You know he wants to get that revenge off that hit from Jake Schultz. He wants to find the back of the net and send Elmira's season to the end.
Samaro playing it off the wall, poked away from Boyalar. Elmira with numbers now. Gaeta holding, tried to center, nobody there. Excellent play by Weaver, getting his skate in the way. Parker's turnaround. A little dipsy doozy. Gets it over to Rasmus Asp and played around the wall by the defenseman. Rasp already retreating. Assuming Binghamton was gonna get to the loose puck, they finally do, is Weaver. Gets it over to Logar, nice little spinorama. Fine boy, Lara. Now the Black Bears come into the offensive side. Weaver just gets it deep enough to the faceoff circles and is given a second opportunity here. Stretch pass onto the tape of Utoro. Blows by Powell. Center up to Kirkby. Looking through the five hole. Bernard made the save. Loose puck still available. Weaver elects not to pinch. Gets back defensively. This is a two-on-two rush. Now two-on-one. A shot. Mackinanima made the save. Wilson lost his stick in the process. Binghamton flows this one down. The length of the ice not going to make the line for icing. Clark on the forecheck. 48 shots on goal for the Black Bears. Look out! And that puck gets deflected into section 10 in the fourth row. Lucky fans going home with a souvenir. Black Bears tied the game up at 3. Back with you after this.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Old Vestal Road in Vestal. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Whether you're a high school or college athlete or a weekend warrior, Guthrie is the area's premier sports medicine program, offering injury evaluation, concussion management, physical therapy, and more. With a full team of providers across New York and Pennsylvania offering same or next day appointments, Guthrie gets you back in the game as quickly as possible. Call the Guthrie Sports Medicine team today at 866-GUTHRIE or learn more at guthrie.org/sportsmed.
.928 left to go here in a tied 3-3 contest. Capacity crowd on hand here for the final regular season game of the season. This could be the matchup next weekend in round one. While you still have your computer up, Cole, update everybody on the Watertown Blue Ridge game, will you?
Well, Watertown's tacked on another one here. When the beginning of the third, it's 4-1 down in the Apex Center, so it looks like if Elmira wants to make the playoffs, they're going to have to do it themselves.
Elmira needs at least 1 point. If they come up empty-handed in regulation, their season could be done. Clink now skating in. He has two goals, looking for the third. Could not get it deep past the Black Bears defender in the form of Bond. BJ's Wholesale Club third period's been a good one. Binghamton with goals a minute and 5 seconds apart. One from Stefan, one from Smith. Kyle Stefan, only Black Bear tonight with multiple points. And the crowd will boo and jeer Yarwood for not moving the puck. It's not a bad idea.
They're just trying to get 1 point, right? They're trying to get themselves to 1 point is huge for them, so not a bad move by Yarwood to kill some clock at all.
Yeah, that point gained by Elmira doesn't hurt. Binghamton has a point lost. Now Bond skates in, tries to hit the trail man in Thompson, but Klink was able to knock down that pass. Back over to Bond as it bounces around. Now Klink just outside the face-off circle. Flashing the leather is Bernard with a glove save.
Yeah, and Bernard got that with the glove. It looks like here comes Jake Schultz back to go serve a penalty. He's entered the playing surface.
So they just announced with the sellout tonight, it is the seventh of the season. Over 110,000 fans have come through the doors this year. An FPHL record once again. So thank you, fans. Even if you're not here tonight watching along on YouTube, we want to thank you for being a part of the action with us all season long. We caught a lot of slack at the beginning of the year for not being on the radio, but I think the product that we've been able to put out on the YouTube feed has been phenomenal, and the support has been amazing all year long. I enjoy doing video broadcasts with you, Cole, with Alex, when Bobby filled in. Everybody has made this season and year one to remember.
Well, Brooks, you know you're doing something right when your broadcaster comes home with some hardware, so I'm going to say that you did something right to come home with that FPHL Broadcaster of the Year.
And then this will be my final point on it. I am not the story. I'm just the storyteller. The Black Bears and the way that they've played all season long have been the amazing story, and let me be a part of this ride. Binghamton dropping it into the zone. Smith trying to find Stefan. Maybe a little too cute on the passing right there as this one gets floated out towards center ice, and Fitzgerald going down like his shortstop brother, taking a grounder on the infield, making sure that puck doesn't get behind him. Collins' older brother, Ryan, middle infielder for the Kansas City Royals farm system. Logar whacking at the loose puck. It bounces into the blue paint. Bernard didn't see it until the last second, and he'll put his mitt on top of it.
Yeah, back to Fitzgerald's brother, Brooks, taken in the Rule 5 draft this year by Kansas City from Boston. So Kansas City really wanted to get their hands on him. He's now in AAA Omaha, so knocking on the door of the major leagues. Hopefully it's not during the postseason, because as much as Colin should be here, it's a once-in-a-lifetime to watch your brother make his MLB debut.
Absolutely. Not too long ago, Ryan Fitzpatrick, older brother of Colin, passed through Binghamton when he was playing a part of the Red Sox AA system. Fitzgerald shot right on cue, is on target, but this time Bernard has the save ready to go. 7 minutes left to go here. Shots 53. Binghamton, Elmira 23.
Yeah, we saw this similar in First Arena the other day when Binghamton put up big numbers. They were getting shots at Bernard, and he really couldn't do anything about it.
PB and Fletcher line up in the faceoff circle. Fletcher knocks it into the corner. Where Somero took that big hit from Jake Schultz. Looks to have shaken that off and seems to be A-OK. Parker sent into the wall by Fitzgerald. He flies in, centering pass, thrown right back into the dark corner on that bottom right-hand side of your screen. Binghamton changing their forwards, top line, making their way out onto the ice.
Brooks, if someone's going to get this go-ahead goal for the Black Bears, my money is on number 17. He's been all over the ice hunting for 40. I think he's going to find it. to give them the 4-3 lead. That's my prediction. I was right about the CF Moto. We'll see if I'm right about this one. And if I am right, I'm buying a lottery ticket.
Can you play the lottery in New York at 18?
Yes, you can.
Okay. And just making sure.
I'm 20, so I can play. Only 20 for another week, though. We're almost there, almost over the hump.
Off the draw, Clark's shot deflected. That one goes over the safety net. Look out. And both corner sections tonight have seen a puck fall into their stand over the safety net. I can't believe that.
I hope we have enough pucks. Fans going home with a lot of souvenirs tonight.
This time, puck makes its way to Gignac and thrown right back in by Dan Weber. However, it was outside the blue line, so Binghamton forced to retreat temporarily. Pickford cut in front of his own net and went right behind it. Didn't like what he saw up front from the Elmira forwards. Clink now skating in on the backhander. Power move denied and then wiped away by McAnanima. Boylar now is trying to settle it down. That was Elmira's 24th shot of the night. Newman with the pickpocket of Boylar back up to the line. Gignac, a shot, rings it off the crossbar. Loose puck still available. Binghamton tries to clear. Thompson settling it down. Multiple players losing their sticks in the process. And Binghamton dodges a bullet, now coming back to offense. Thompson slapper blocked on the way through by a defenseman. And the forwards are going to get off for a line change. Clark will stay on temporarily.
I believe next whistle, Jake Schultz and Dustin Gesso will return, Brooks.
Boylar pushes the puck back in towards the Elmira blue line. And this one's going to be tipped, say the linesman, so no icing is asked. But gets to the puck first just outside the trapezoid. Tosto locates the puck, but Gaeta got there first. And the young Elmira forward, who's been impressive all year long with 24 goals, 22 assists. Has it taken away. Steffen now. Wrapping it around the half wall. Bernard out to play it. Off the glass. Pinched. Temporarily, but it works out for the River Sharks as it bounces right onto the stick of the big defenseman, Rasmus Asp. Binghamton crossing back over the line. Steffen, a shot. Blockered away. Just getting into the safety net. Out of play. 4:29 left to go here. We're going down the stretch in Binghamton. 3-3 the score. Back with you after this.
Are you ready to take your billiards game to a whole new level? Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop has everything you need to impress your friends and crush your opponents. American Q Sports certified coach Kim the Dragon Young is now accepting new students. From novices to pros, the Dragon helps you find your best game with in-person or online instruction available worldwide. Need help with stance, stroke, or alignment and aiming? We've got you covered. Looking for advanced cue control techniques and trick shots? No problem. Follow us on Facebook at Dragon Billiards Instruction and Instagram at Dragon Billiards Kim for free daily tips and drills, upcoming tournaments and events, as well as exciting contests and giveaways. Subscribe on Patreon for personalized video content. Visit our online pro shop for the lowest prices on the highest quality pool cues, accessories, and Dragon Billiards gear. Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop, breathing fire into your game.
Welcome back, everybody. 4:29 left to go here. Third period brought to you by BJ's Wholesale Club. Let's see if Cole's prediction can come true. Utoro off the draw, blocked by Wilson. His stick exploded on him. Gets a new twig. Dylan Konechny with the handoff. Utoro comes right back into the play, but while that was going on, it gets deflected into the net once again.
Well, those CPR safety nets have seen their fair share of work tonight, Brooks. A lot of pucks coming their way. Couldn't stop them all. Some of them have even reached the seats.
You know, shout out our friend Joey from CPR and Red Barn Technologies, starring in that commercial all season long. Definitely got their money's worth tonight.
Yes, yes they have.
and even the pucks that go over the safety net as well.
And there's been plenty of those, too.
Face-off win by Elmira. Jasso is out of the box. So is Schultz. Both of those players on the ice. Jasso has his stick lifted by Utoro, and then Jasso dropped his stick in the process. Jasso is trying to soccer this one away, and a glove save made from the wall. And we have a whistle.
I think the referee blew its head, but nobody heard it, so the linesman was helping him out there.
So, offensive zone draw for the River Sharks, Parker against Kirkby. This one will find the stick of Kirkby, and he played that right off the well a little too well. As Powell soccers this one ahead, temporarily, right in front of the two benches. Cameron Clark goes out wide, gets around Klink. Got to be careful with Klink up high as a winger right now. You know he's not going to be afraid to take chances. Clark down low, behind the net. Over to Anderson, a shot deflected on the way through. Elmira tries to clear, held in by the Black Bears at the blue line. Kirkby and Schultz tie up at the corner. Two former captains, or the current captain and the former captain doing battle. Fitzgerald a shot, and Kirkby tried to bunt that one out of midair. Ends up going behind the net of Mack and Anima, loose puck. Turnaround bid from Klink. Beautiful body position by Anderson to nullify that scoring chance. Newman, though, still on the puck through traffic. McAnanima sees it, and he'll hang on.
Well, Elmira fighting for their lives. 2 minutes and 56 seconds. They have to get to that finish line with this score at least tied, because 6-1 is what it reads last time we checked down in Withville. So it's all in their hands. Can they keep it going and set themselves up for a rematch next week?
So now Wilson off the faceoff win by Jasso, plays it around to the Elmira center, and Weber beat Jasso to the spot, pokes the puck away. And Binghamton now skates this one in. They dump it behind Bernard, run into by Stefan. Always got to be careful with making contact with the goaltender, especially behind the net. You don't want to take a penalty here late in this one. This one's sent down the ice. McAnanima comes out of his net, played off the wall, while Elmira is temporary offsides. They got Jasso waiting to touch up at the blue line, and now they're good to go. Wilson couldn't corral that puck, and it gets to the Black Bears blue liners. Boylar and Weaver play catch. Penalty coming up against Elmira, and Black Bears are headed back to the Henny Hard Seltzer power play.
It'll be Kyle Powell taking a seat for the trip, and the Black Bears will pretty much finish this period out unless they can score on the power play. Only going to be 8 seconds of time if the River Sharks can get it that far. So if there was ever a time for the power play that's been 0-4 to score, Brooks, it's now.
Yeah, Henny Hard Seltzer power play. Be bold, choose flavor, choose Henny Hard Seltzer. Binghamton 0-2 on the power play tonight, but that can change in a blink of an eye.
Yep, now it's played back, and here's Logar to pinch it in at the blue line. Logar sends it in deep, and it's met there. Shot, Tosto went wide.
Oh boy, that would have lit the place on fire. Elmira able to clear, and this might be the longest 2 minutes in Kyle Powell's season.
It's going to be the longest two in River Sharks franchise history, I'll tell you that.
They made it all the way to game 56 with an opportunity to make it into the playoffs, something that the Elmira Mammoth did not do last year. No, excuse me, they played Danbury. My fault, I apologize. Tosto now skates in. Played around the wall as Tosto took the hit. Thompson takes a whack as well. Pickford and Thompson with a couple of more whacks for each other, as Elmira doing a good job so far of killing the clock and also getting the puck deep.
And Brooks, you weren't technically wrong. Elmira Mammoth did not go to game 56 trying to clinch a spot. They had clinched it earlier, so don't beat yourself up too much.
Smith with a nice move up at the blue line. Clean entry for the Black Bears. 60 seconds left to go in the third period. Can somebody be the hero in regulation time? Here's Smith with the puck. Backhand to the forehand, scores! Connor Smith does it again! 4-3, Binghamton leads!
What a goal, and he hypes up the crowd. Well, you've earned it, Cowboy. Gets himself right into the slot. Just crashes, shoots, and scores right in front of his former captain, Jake Schultz, and I bet you that stung. And Kyle Powell, it's going to sting him too, as he was the one who was sitting in the box. And I think Smitty might have bought himself a couple minutes for the celebration.
Austin Thompson sitting down.
Oh, that's Austin Thompson, excuse me.
So, a power play goal when you needed it the most. Connor Smith delivers his second of the game.
That is a workout lift in that chair, Brooks. You were right. It's a burger goal too, Brooks. So the fans still going home with that Burger King coupon, something they've grown quite accustomed to this year. I think it's only not happened once. That might have been a couple weeks ago against Danbury, or last week against Danbury when it was 2-1. They still won. Here it is. Connor Smith might have just ended Elmira's season on that play right there. Still 53 seconds for the River Sharks to respond, but it's going to be tough to beat Connor McAnanima. I'm sure we'll see Sammy Bernard to the bench sooner than later. But both teams have talked it over. I believe Coach Church used his timeout. And here we go, Brooks.
53 seconds left to go. I need a week for my voice to recover. Bernard goes towards the empty net. Kirkley floats it down the ice. Not on target. This is icing against the Black Bears. 38 seconds left to go.
I'm sure Kirkby's going to be firing. He really wants that 40. Kyle Steffen with another point tonight. He has been sensational in this comeback effort for the Triple Bs. And if they can hold on, I'm sure that's going to be one vibrant locker room after the game.
So Austin Thompson gets him his McConda for inciting an opponent. Stays in the box. McAnanima save right on the doorstep. Kirkby clearing out just so in front of the blue paint. 20 seconds left to go. Stone just pinning it against the wall. It makes its way out, elevated by Kirkby. It's not going to make the line. 12 seconds left to go. Big pile up in the other end. And I didn't hear a whistle. And it looks, okay, they stopped the clock. There is a whistle.
Is that Jesso in the middle of it again? I can't really see from here, I believe it is. No, it's Pickford. Pickford in the middle once again tonight.
Live look at the out-of-town scoreboard with 9 seconds left in this one. There's 9 seconds left. Watertown is up 6-2 over Blue Ridge. Watertown will pick up 3 points. Elmira still has a chance with 10 seconds left. Not going to get ahead of ourselves.
But the most likely outcome. Oh, I thought that was your phone, Brooks.
That would have been sick.
Is that Trevor's?
It might be.
The most likely outcome, though, as of right now, will be the Black Bears heading up to the North Country for game one.
So a broken stick on the way through. That's going to get cleaned up off the ice. The referee trying to explain everything. And they want a neutral zone draw. I don't know if they're going to get it.
I think they're asking for it because the altercation was in the Binghamton end, but the puck was in the Elmira end. So we'll have to see what the referees decide. This could be crucial, Brooks, because it'll either force Elmira for one last entry, or they're going to get to enter. They're going to be in the zone to start. So we'll see what they come to. And it looks like they're going to come to the neutral zone.
Yeah, linesman with his skate in the center ice face-off dot. Makes it that much more difficult for Elmira.
Fans here in Binghamton going nuts, appreciating it.
Now referees are going to step into the penalty box. I don't see them looking at the tablet. I think they just want to explain everything to the off-ice guys and Frank Perney. Also, how they know they can make this announcement.
Yep. And you heard the Binghamton faithful going nuts. They've supported these Black Bears all season, and have they put a show on the ice for them. First in the Empire, they captured a banner that'll probably go up next season. And the job's not done, but they can enjoy the small victories. And I'm sure if tonight ends in the side of the Black Bears, this will be one of them.
Pete's killing it tonight with the music. Big shout out to our friend Pete, the DJ. Been on the MC all season long. Frank Perney in the penalty box as the PA announcer. Director of Game Ops, Trevor Potenziano. Ticket Director and Merchandise, Bobby Gross. Kelsey Lane up in the front office. And Alex Jones in group sales. It's a total team effort from the front office here tonight that has come to fruition with 7 sellouts. Final push for Elmira. It's wiped away. It doesn't matter. It is done. Binghamton comes back from down 3-1 going into the third period, and the Black Bears emerge victorious.
They end the River Sharks season and pit themselves with a date against the Watertown Wolves. First one will be up in the North Country, and then the next one will be right here in front of these fans.
We're going to take a timeout, come back, recap this one. Binghamton leads, wins 4-3 here in the regular season home finale.
Jersey, bring us the hitties!
Yeah! All right, I got the hitties.
Baby. A win like that calls for a real celebration.
Oh, yeah. I have one on.
Getting your hands on an all-new CF Moto side-by-side or four-wheeler is now easier than ever at ExciteMotorsports.com. Purchase your next power sports vehicle with our new, easy, and quick online buying experience. Browse inventory on ExciteMotorsports.com. Buy, get approved for financing, and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride, have your new power sports vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra charge. Browse, buy, ride. Fun starts here at ExciteMotorsports.com.
Welcome back in, everybody. What a way to cap off game 56. We knew it was going to be exciting. All the desperation in the world for the River Sharks. But Connor Smith steps up, grabs a pair of goals in the third period. And that is the difference maker here. As we get to the Rocco J. Testani, 3 stars of the game. Third star of the game. Stephen Klink, the third star of the game. And Kyle Steffen continues to impress, taking home the second star of the night. And the first star, no surprise who was going to be here tonight, Cole, the Cowboy, Connor Smith.
I'll let Frank say it because he'll say it better. Sensational from Connor Smith. He has been all season. And who else would you expect but the Cowboy to wrangle home this victory? And Brooks, I know that there's a power play post show kind of mojo, but there also might be a Tully's coaches show with Kyle Steffen.
Absolutely, a game of fruition for everything. First game will be on Friday at the Watertown Municipal Arena. Saturday, Black Bears back home, and Sunday if necessary.
Yeah, and Brooks, the Wolves are going to be a tough task. We know that they are with Trevor Lord, Tate Leeson. We've seen them quite a few times, but it's all up to the Black Bears to go take care of an arena that they've had some trouble in. They've had some trouble up in Watertown, but the playoffs are a different animal, so we'll see if the Black Bears put it all together like we know they can, like they have all season, and show up ready for a battle with the Wolves.
Absolutely. Cole, excellent job this season, but the job is not done yet. We're excited to have you on once again during the playoffs next week, and hopefully the next few weeks after that as well. We've come a long way from the Kids Corner, and we're very excited for your broadcasting future.
Well, thanks so much, Brooks. I learned from one of the best, you know. FPHL Broadcast of the Year doesn't come easy, and growing up with the organization has been special. I've been here since day one, and last year I had to leave a little early because of a wedding. I'm here till for the long haul for this one, Brooks, as long as it goes.
Well, that's awesome. Peter, excellent job all season long. A new addition to the video team with us has done excellent on the ones and twos all year long. We thank everybody who has come through the doors and watched any single game on YouTube. The good news is the Black Bears aren't done yet. Friday night in Watertown, there will be a YouTube stream. I will guarantee it. We're gonna figure out the rest of the details, but there will be a stream. You can write that one down, take it to the bank. They're open on Saturdays. I know I went today.
Tomorrow's Sunday, Brooks.
Don't take it tomorrow. I'm just saying they're open on Saturdays. Saturday night, home game against Watertown in a best of three. Puck drop, 7 p.m. Tickets at BinghamtonBlackBears.com or 607-722-7367. If necessary, Sunday, game three, 6 p.m. puck drop, 1 hour earlier, just so everybody has all the details they need.
And if you're listening at home or you're in the arena tonight, come on down for the playoff game. Pack the arena. Show the support for your Black Bears. It's going to be a great one. And they've showed you all season long. But if you can't make it, check out me and Brooks on YouTube. Thank you for supporting them the whole way, though. And thank you for supporting us.
For Josh Williams and his entire video team, super producer Peter up here on the ones and twos with us, my partner Cole Parenti. My name is Brooks Hill, signing off, telling you there will be at least two more Black Bears games. We're hoping for more, but games 57 and 58 coming up next week. We'll talk to you then, live on YouTube, Friday night from the Watertown Municipal Arena. Have a good one, everybody.